fun. And here's Coach Slot. Shot save. Cole get on the doorstep, and he'll hang on.
Four.
Rebound. Onto the boards, chance in front for Russell, and he's denied point blank by Colgan.
Three.
To the high slot area, kept it up top, Coach with a shot tipped in front. Colgan the save, they jam away at the rebound, and Colgan able to trap it.
Two.
Plays it away to the wall, chance in front, Nielsen a shot, Colgan, big save, and he holds on.
One.
And now the pass picked up by Nielsen, he walks in, trying to feed it across, Colgan a right pad, save on the deflection there. And here's Coach Slot. Shot save. Colgan on the doorstep. Hello, everyone, and welcome in once again this week to Cali's Corner. I'm Tom Callahan, voice of the Columbus River Dragons. Columbus coming off only one game on the weekend. It was a big 7-2 win over the Mississippi Seawolves, but they get right back to it Wednesday and Thursday in Mississippi, Friday against the Carolina Thunderbirds. We talked to River Dragons head coach Jerome Bichard about his thoughts about trying to manage personnel with only one game last week, but a short week this week.
Morsey will go back with, McDonald and... Hunter and things will kind of change up, and we'll just kind of wait and see. The guys have been really responsive as far as going back and forth between Andreoli and Orswan playing, but now I got to make a kind of a tough decision here on who's in and who's out.
Defenseman Hugh Anderson made his rookie debut on Friday night. We asked his thoughts about jumping to pro.
It was so much fun. Guys made it really enjoyable for me. Made it easy on me, let me play.
And as it turned out, Anderson even had his first pro assist added to the final goal of the game later on. We asked him his thoughts about getting that first point out of the way.
Yeah, I saw that. Got a couple texts after the game. Pretty stoked about it. So
the River Dragons back at it Wednesday, Thursday night in Mississippi against the Seawolves, and then home Friday, March 8th on Sensory Awareness Night against the Carolina Thunderbirds. Game time is 7:35 p.m. and tickets are on sale right now through the Civic Center box office and online at Ticketmaster.com. For Cali's Corner, I'm Tom Callahan. And here's Coach Slot. Shot save. Colgan on the doorstep, and he'll hang on. Rebound onto the boards. Chance in front for Russell, and he's denied point blank by Colgan.
Three.
To the high slot area. Kept it up top. Coach with a shot tipped in front. Colgan the save. They jam away at the rebound, and Colgan able to trap it.
Two.
Plays it away to the wall. Chance in front. Nielsen a shot. Colgan, big save. And he holds on.
One.
And now the pass picked up by Nielsen. He walks in, trying to feed it across. Colgan, a right pad save on the deflection there.
You gotta fight for your right to want. Hey.
As well at Columbus River Dragons. It's time for the Air Force Heating and Air pregame show. From the Mississippi Gulf Coast Coliseum, and we're just about at the end. Mike Knight, number 2 and 3 in a row for the River Dragons, taking to the ice here. Last night, they won against Mississippi right here in this building to start it off. An unusual Wednesday night contest tonight. Also a little odd, we have a Thursday night contest, and we are the only game in the FPHL here tonight, but there's plenty going on in the NHL this evening, and plenty going on with the NHL trade deadline coming up tomorrow. Now, I actually misspoke on that yesterday. I am so used to, for years and years and years, the trade deadline was on a Monday. And I kept saying next week. It's a Friday. And it is tomorrow, 3 p.m. Eastern Time, meaning that trade deadline will pass. And so we are going to spend some time talking about what's going on in the NHL, because I know you have a lot of your podcasts. We do listen to the River Dragons, but we'll save that for the interview. We will talk about it in the pregame with Zelmo Zippin out of town scoreboard, but that's a couple of segments from now. As the River Dragons here, we're going to set up this matchup instead, talking about this game, because it's a big one for Columbus here, as they yesterday became the first team over 100 points. 101 now, exactly. Come into this. 31-4-2-2-1 on the season. That's an .842 win percentage. Columbus remains the only team in the 800s on the win percentage. And I'll tell you what, 31 regulation wins, also the highest total in the FPHL. This River Dragons team has been doing very well with that as well. Out of the 40 games they've played this year, Columbus has just been on an absolute tear. Also, their plus 107 goal differential, best in the FPHL as well. I mean, they've really just been tearing it up this season. But yesterday, the Seawolves kept it close. It was a game that Mississippi, which comes in as 21-3-2-2. That's 53 points there. And the fourth and final playoff spot this month. And the Seawolves yesterday kind of actually played a bit of a boring, monotonous game, but in a lot of ways, it didn't let the River Dragons open things up offensively. Now, the Seawolves, prior to the coaching change, were a team that I think would have traded Taylor had gone chance for chance, would have opened it up. They still do try to stretch it a little bit. You can see some fundamental changes in the way this team is playing the game. And I think it's very interesting to see the shift happening for Mississippi, because there's about a little more than a month left in the regular season here. And the Seawolves, if they do change the way they play, change their game, it's kind of like going through training camp again with not a lot of time left in the regular season. So to try to grasp the fundamentals of how they're going to change, how they're going to attack, how they're going to defend, power play, penalty kill. It's difficult to make grand sweeping changes this late in the season, but if Mississippi is going to really live again, honestly, they have to, because they're missing some key pieces now. Anthony Arakos is gone from the team. He was suspended by the club and has left the Seawolves. You're not going to see Yanni anymore with the Seawolves hockey team. You're also not going to see Sam Turner, the defenseman. He's out for the year. He's moved into an assistant coach position, but he's done for the rest of the season as far as playing. So that's a big miss for the Seawolves as well. So fundamentally, they have to shift. I think those are two very key players for them. They are still going to be without Rich Pinkowski tonight, and got a little bit of an update earlier today talking with some folks from the Seawolves side. He took a puck in the face in practice earlier this week, just below the eye. Lucky it didn't get him in the eye. But took a puck below the eye, and it looks like he might be heading to the IR relatively soon. Hasn't been assigned to it yet, but would not be surprised if he did end up on that IR list. So we do have a couple other things to talk about for Mississippi as far as their roster moves and what have you. We'll be talking about those and taking a look back over at the transaction wire as well here in the FPHL. There's just an awful lot going on around the league right now, and you know what, some teams trying to make some shuffles, some changes, trying to get themselves right. Because right now, quite frankly, we're in a spot where, hey, if you're able to get the team you want down the stretch and get that team to come together, to coalesce, and be functioning like a well-oiled machine into the playoffs, that's where you have your best chance of going on your run. I think if you add a guy a week before the playoffs start, there's a good chance that that's going to disrupt more than it's going to actually add to the cohesion. And so for a lot of teams, I think the impetus is now trying to get those players in, get them acclimated, and get them playoff ready. So there's a lot to get to here in our Air Force Heating and Air pregame show. We will talk more about what's going on in Mississippi and, of course, Columbus as well. Plus, we do have that look at the Zelmo zipping out of town scoreboard and our pregame chat, as always, with River Dragons head coach Jerome Bichard. All that and more is coming your way in just a little bit, so stay tuned. The Seawolves and the River Dragons dropping the puck just past the top of the hour. This is Columbus River Dragons hockey.
Winter is upon us. We must prepare. Cold and darkness will spread across the land. The nights will be long.
Hey, what are you guys doing? Air Force is here to fix the heat.
Don't let winter leave you out in the cold. Call Air Force Heating and Air now for our special $79 AC gas furnace or heat pump tune-up, only for a limited time. Air Force Heating and Air is always here for you.
We all dream, but dreams quickly become distant memories unless we do something about it. Do everything in our power to learn to lead. At Troy University, we teach everyone to be leaders in their field. We're dedicated to teaching a new generation to lead change.
Get two entrees and an appetizer for $25 only at Applebee's.
Good internet.
With WOW, you now get upfront surprise-free pricing with Wi-Fi modem included and no data caps, all for only $30 a month with autopay and paperless billing.
WOW.
I'm always on the go. But with the Kinetic Credit Union app, Kinetic is always with me. The Kinetic mobile app is virtual banking at its best. With the Kinetic mobile app, I can easily send and receive money, make a deposit, pay some bills, and I can even open up a new account, all from my phone. And I can monitor all my accounts in one place, all on the go. The Kinetic mobile app, energized banking at its best.
Kinetic Credit Union, the energy for your dreams.
And we are back in the Air Force Heating and Air pregame show. Tom Callahan here with you. Thanks for joining us. And my producer, Drew Pierce, also spinning knobs, punching things on the mouse, the keyboard, just making himself look busy, I think, is what Drew's best at over there. And that's what he's been doing. So nice job, Drew. But right now, the River Dragons and the Seawolves finishing up warm-ups here at the Mississippi Gulf Coast Coliseum. And we appreciate you being here. At River Dragons, second game of a 3-3 here tonight. We are back home tomorrow night, and I want to remind everybody that tomorrow night is a sensory adaptive night in conjunction with Easter Seals. It is against the Carolina Thunderbirds, and
We're going to still have the same show. We're just dialing it down a little bit. Less volume, less flashing lights. And, you know, really hoping that folks who don't normally get a chance to appreciate and enjoy live River Dragons hockey because of those sensory issues are able to come out. Now, we do still have a sensory adaptive room. If you come to the game and it's still a little much, you need a place to just kind of bring it down another notch or two. If you head to our concierge table outside section 201, you'll be able to be escorted to that room on our suite level. So we will make sure that we have things set up in there and that, you know, we're able to take care of everybody and help as best as we can for those nights. And it's important to give back to the community, but to all members of the community and the Chattahoochee Valley and the River Dragons. Very proud to be able to partner with Easter Seals and to do this game again this year. It was a success last year. We look forward to it being a success again this season. So here on the Air Force Heating and Air pregame show, a couple of things I wanted to get to talk about here. First of all, just taking a look at the wire today in the FPHL, the Blue Ridge Bobcats have done a couple of different things, and it's kind of interesting, but was pointed out to me that Max Sazanovitz has been hired as the equipment manager. Of course, he played a couple of games for Blue Ridge, and now assistant coach, former River Dragon, Christian Pavlos. Pavlos was released, and I know he's been going through some lower body injury stuff. I believe he's had some issues with his knees. Trying to get past that. I don't know if that's it for Pavlos or not, but maybe for this year it is. But he has been hired on as an assistant coach of the Blue Ridge Bobcats. Also, Blue Ridge put Cody Oaks over on the 15-day IR as Pavlos moved off of that IR. So a couple other moves that happened today. The Motor City Rockers released Tim Delaney on waivers. And for the Seawolves, yesterday they got a guy back off suspension. Well, they get another one back here today. Yesterday it was Lucas Helland returning from suspension. Today it's Tyson Lambert done serving his two-gamer. And so Lambert back into the lineup for Mississippi here today as they try to get back at the River Dragons for the defeat yesterday. Columbus ended up with an empty net goal late from Alexander Jemayev. Yesterday, Justin McDonald, a goal and an assist, extending his league record point streak to 30 consecutive games with a point. McDonald now has a point in every game since December 1st. And over that stretch, 25 goals, 44 assists, 69 points. Unbelievable stretch out of Justin McDonald. He's almost 2.3 points per game in that little stretch there. Well, it's really not a little stretch anymore, actually, is it? I mean, 30 games is more than half the season in this league. It's just incredible what he continues to do and just finds ways to take over games when he needs to. And he is absolutely a force to be reckoned with in the FPHL. And you know what? Hopefully he's a guy who can lead this team back to a championship here this year. Certainly, I know River Dragons fans all have their fingers crossed, but McDonald comes in. He's leading the league in points, leading the league in assists, leading the league in plus minus. That's one of the more impressive things. He's plus 52 on the year. By the way, the top three spots belong to River Dragons. Kyle Morris plus 44, Ryan Hunter plus 43. Those are his line mates. But that line has been absolutely dominant. And what it also tells you is not only are they scoring a lot, but they're not getting scored upon 5-on-5. And that doesn't even include, the plus 52 doesn't look at McDonald's contributions in the power play, but just absolutely incredible having a look at what he's been able to do. And just a great season out of Justin McDonald, one for the record books. And hopefully, River Dragons fans, you're appreciating it right along with me, just watching this guy night in, night out, and absolutely loving what he has a chance to do. Every time he's out there, touches the puck, he could just take over the game in a heartbeat. The good news is the River Dragons come into tonight as well on a Tim Hortons win streak. Three in a row for the River Dragons coming into tonight. Join Tim's Rewards today and get any flavor medium cold drink in your first week when you sign up. Visit timhortons.com or download the app in your app store today, and you too can join Tim's Rewards. Columbus back on that streak after the 16-gamer. That was a franchise record earlier this year, one short of the Columbus record. And in talking with the captain, Josh Petrantonio, when it was broken, when I told him, I said, hey, it was 17. We missed it by one game. And he said, wait, how many games are left in the season? Well, we figured out that the River Dragons could put together a 19-game run to finish the season. And so he said, you know what, that's the new goal. We're gonna do that. So if Columbus rips off 19 in a row to finish the regular season, that would be absolutely amazing. It would be very Norfolk Admirals en route to the Calder Cup. Well, I was going to say about a decade ago, but it's longer than that now. John Cooper, the current coach of the Lightning, was actually the coach of that team back in the day. That was an epic, epic run. If you want to go down a hockey rabbit hole and you got a little extra time on your hands, check that out at some point. But, boy, that team was just dominant down the stretch through the playoffs. Maybe the River Dragons can heat up on a similar level and try to find a way to win this year's Commissioner's Cup title. We have our out-of-town scoreboard to get to, which is brought to you by Zelmo Zippin. We'll do that. We are also going to take a look at the NHL trade deadline, men's college hoops. There's two games going on today, so we'll fill you in on that as well. So stay tuned. There is more coming your way in just a moment. Time for us to take a break. But again, puck drop coming up just past the top of the hour. The Mississippi Seawolves and the Columbus River Dragons. The Air Force Heating and Air pregame show rolls on River Dragons Hockey.
At Beam, we take pride in being a part of our community, and we're committed to seeing it grow. We continually volunteer with organizations that are making a difference. Together, we are building a better community while building the best internet that exceeds the technology of metropolitan cities. But more importantly, one that connects us all. We want to ensure reliability. So for this reason, we're willing to go the extra mile. We aim to provide the community with high-quality internet and cable services because we live here too. Because at Beam, community is not just a place. It's the way we do business.
Must prepare. Cold and darkness will spread across the land. The nights will be long.
Hey, what are you guys doing? Air Force is here to fix the heat.
Don't let winter leave you out in the cold. Call Air Force Heating and Air now for our special $79 AC gas furnace or heat pump tune-up, only for a limited time. Air Force Heating and Air is always here for you.
Hi-ho, hi-ho, your gas is getting low, but you're in luck, pull your car or truck into Zelmo's, Zelmo's, Zelmo's.
This month at Zelmo's, all Celsius energy drinks, 2 for $4.
But you're in luck, pull your car or truck into Zelmo's, Zelmo's, Zelmo's.
Always clean, always fast, always friendly. Zelmo's Zip-In, fueling life's passions for 20 years.
On the Chick-fil-A app, real guests paid for their testimonials.
Hello, everyone. Welcome back. We missed you. We're back. It's the Air Force Heating and Air pregame show. Tom Callahan here with you. Drew Pierce is to my right, just giggling. So sometimes you gotta keep them guessing, Drew. Gotta keep them guessing. So thanks to the radio audience on 106.9 Rocks tuning us in here this evening, and also along the YouTube feed at Columbus River Dragons. Every game this season, and really across the FPHL, we bring those games to you free of charge on YouTube because we want to grow the game, and we appreciate you being just a part of hockey in general. You don't have to be a fan of the River Dragons, and many of you watching tonight may not be. You may be fans of other teams because we're the only game in the FPHL here tonight, but we just want to grow the game of hockey. We want to support it at the youth level, the adult level. Get people on skates who've never tried it before. You might find your next new hobby, new passion, new calling. Who knows? But it's just a fantastic sport. Once you're bitten by the bug, boy, it's awful, awful hard to let go. But hope you're having fun, whatever you're doing tonight, and we appreciate you being here. Well, let's take a look at the Zelmo Zippin' out-of-town scoreboard. And as I mentioned, we are the only game in the FPHL tonight, and we will drop the puck here in about 15-ish minutes or so. In the NHL, out-of-town, you've got the Boston Bruins up 1-0 on the Toronto Maple Leafs. David Pastrnak with his 39th on the power play for the Bees to put them up. At the first intermission, the Canadiens and Hurricanes are tied up at 1. Blue Jackets out to a 3-0 lead on the Edmonton Oilers after the first period in that one. Go Columbus. How about that? That's a pretty darn good start for them. And Alexander Nylander has another goal for the Blue Jackets. So, you know what? Kind of a under-the-radar trade for the Blue Jackets, but, boy, that looks pretty good for them right now. All right, first intermission as well. Flyers, Panthers scoreless. And Devils 2-0 up on the Blues after one period of play. Just about to head to the intermission. Capitals 1-0 over the Penguins. Tom Wilson is 14th. Flames, Lightning are tied at 1 in the first intermission. Everybody watching, that's one of the teams everybody's watching, is to see if Jacob Markstrom's going anywhere. And if he'll be traded, that's the trade deadline again coming up tomorrow in the NHL. That's a big one. Sabres are at the Preds tonight. Wild are at the Coyotes. So Sabres Preds is 8 Eastern, 9 Eastern, Wild at Coyotes, 10 Eastern, Canucks at Golden Knights, 10:30. Senators are on the left coast against the Kings, and the Islanders are at the Sharks. That's also a 10:30 puck drop. So a pretty full slate of games tonight. In the National Hockey League on a Thursday night before the trade deadline, more action today going down in the world of the NHL trade tracker. And I'll give that a moment to refresh here, because I'll tell you, college hoops, there's only 2 games tonight. Neither one of them have tipped off yet. 9:30 Eastern, number 5 Arizona's at UCLA. And at 9 o'clock Eastern time, Washington's at number 18, Washington State, as what's left of that Pac-12 goes through their machinations here. Boy, it's going to be a totally different landscape next year in college sports, isn't it? All right, so trade tracker for you. Trades that were made today. I will talk about the major ones from yesterday in a moment. This one actually came in pretty late last night, so I'll lump it into today. But defenseman Noah Hanifin went to the Vegas Golden Knights for defenseman Daniil Miromanov and a couple of picks, a conditional 2025 first rounder and a 25 third rounder to the Calgary Flames. So it looks like the Flames in the seller column here, which is why I think Markstrom may end up on the move here for a team looking for goaltending if they can match the Flames' price. Defenseman Joel Edmondson has gone to the Toronto Maple Leafs for a couple of picks from the Washington Capitals. Anthony Beauvillier, the left wing, picked up by the Predators for a fifth rounder from the Blackhawks. Player for player, Jacob Perreault goes to the Canadiens. Jan Mizak going to the Anaheim Ducks. Brandon Duhaime goes to the Colorado Avalanche, left wing on the move from the Minnesota Wild to get a third rounder. Troy Stecker and a seventh rounder to the Edmonton Oilers for a fourth round pick to the Arizona Coyotes. Yakov Trenin and Graham Sward going to the Colorado Avalanche from the Nashville Predators for defenseman Jeremy Hansel and a 25 third rounder from the Avs. The Avs were busy yesterday. They acquired Casey Mittelstadt from the Buffalo Sabres for defenseman Bowen Byram, after picking up defenseman Sean Walker and a 26 fifth round pick from the Flyers for Ryan Johansson and a 25 conditional first rounder. And that, I'll tell you what, the Avs are really going for it this year and may have put themselves ahead a little bit with those moves. Alex Wenberg goes to the Rangers from the Seattle Kraken for a couple of picks. I really like that move for the Rangers. The Oilers also loading up as they picked up left wing Adam Henrique and center Sean Carrick for the Ducks, along with a seventh rounder for a 24 first round pick and a conditional 25 fifth rounder as well. And another couple of major trades yesterday. And this one, I think, actually, this is the major trade for me from yesterday. Vladimir Tarasenko going to the Florida Panthers from the Ottawa Senators for a fourth rounder and a third rounder. All right, we've got to get to our chat with River Dragons head coach Jerome Bichard. Then on the other side of that, we will indeed be dropping the puck here as the River Dragons and the Mississippi Seawolves going head-to-head for the second night in a row. Can the River Dragons keep this win streak going? Well, only one way to find out. We're back with more in a moment. This is River Dragons Hockey.
We're always going a million different directions.
But Kinetic Credit Union makes it easy for all of us to stay connected all in one place.
With the Kinetic mobile app, we both can monitor our accounts on the go. We can create account alerts so we know when there's a change. Apply for a loan or credit card. We can even open a new account.
Plus, you can quickly pay bills, transfer money, or make a deposit anytime, anywhere.
Kinetic makes our life a whole lot easier.
Kinetic Credit Union, the energy for your dreams.
Good internet. Get upfront surprise-free pricing with Wi-Fi modem included and no data caps. Plus, bundle internet 300 with YouTube TV for just $92.99 per month for 12 months with autopay and paperless billing.
Wow. Just the two of us. We can make it if we try. Just the two of us. Just the two of us.
Get 2 entrees and an appetizer for $25 only at Applebee's.
At Jack Houston Memorial Hospital, our focus is you.
Even though we performed more than 1,300 joint replacements last year, we treat you like you are our only patient. Your surgeon explains your joint replacement, so nothing is a surprise. Our team knows your treatment plan, and we work together to get you back on your feet again. That's why our hospital is recognized year after year as a leader in patient satisfaction and quality of care. Jack Houston Memorial Hospital. Excellence, always.
Winter is upon us. We must prepare. Cold and darkness will spread across the land. The nights will be long.
Hey, what are you guys doing? Air Force is here to fix the heat.
Don't let winter leave you out in the cold. Call Air Force Heating and Air now for our special $79 AC gas furnace or heat pump tune-up, only for a limited time. Air Force Heating and Air is always here for you.
Back in the Air Force Heating and Air pregame show, we're joined by River Dragons head coach Jerome Bichard. Boom, you do come out with a win yesterday, and I know the message to the boys a little bit earlier today. Talk to us a little bit about that in light of yesterday. I mean, Mississippi kind of hangs around. They get one in the third. Now, all of a sudden, it's a different hockey game, and it gets interesting at the end.
Yeah, you know what? I think it was a, I don't know if it was a gutsy win or not. I mean, we, for whatever reason, middle of the week, travel, wasn't our best wasn't our best game. We were pretty sloppy, a lot of turnovers in the neutral zone, a lot of back and forth kind of banter, not a whole lot going on. When we did get it in their end zone, I thought we did have some pretty good success when we scored a couple nice goals and this and that. And I mean, they had a couple good shots, and Frenchie had to make a couple really good saves, but for the most part, kind of a blah game.
Yeah, it really didn't have a whole heck of a lot when you don't have flow like that, when it is just kind of a bit of back and forth, pitch and catch in the neutral zone. Is there a lot you can do as a coach to try to influence that?
Yell and scream at my guys. You know, for whatever reason, we were out of sync. My pregame talk, it'll be about pace. I think our D were playing slow and our forwards were kind of playing fast. And we got to play at the same kind of pace. Our D's got to move our feet, move the puck, and our forwards have to be patient and kind of stay where they're at. We were stretching a little bit, and we were stretching into, you know, their players, and, you know, we're stretching right into a guy, and guy gets a puck on a stick, and it's a turnover, and then we're going back and forth type thing. So kind of slow down a little bit and play a little bit more under control, I think. We're a little all over the map last night.
Justin McDonald has that streak still going, and it seems like at times he can really take over the pace of a hockey game.
You know, he really can. I mean, he uses his body so well. And again, I think we spoke about it. He's not a great skater, and he's not super, super fast, but he's really strong on his feet, and he's got great balance, and he can position the puck and use his body really well to set up plays and hold off people, and you know, he likes to hold off people more than I like to hold on, but at the same time, it's pretty tough to say stop doing what you're doing when he's got 100 and some points maybe, or getting close.
He's almost at 100. At 100.
So, anyways, yeah, he's strong, and anybody that plays with him, you know, obviously benefits from that.
Nathan Bockwell gets his first pro goal. I mean, talk about the season he's had and finally getting that first one out of the way.
Yeah, it was kind of nice to see him get it. You know, he's, you know, Mr. Steady Eddie back there. He's a big guy that can skate well and actually has fairly good hands. And just really nice to see him get rewarded with a nice shot. So sneaking in from the blue line, and that's what I want all my D-men to do, and they tend to get a little too crazy and get a little too more involved than what they need to sometimes.
All right, well, let's wrap it all up. I know it's your favorite part of the whole interview, keys to the game tonight.
You know what, keys to the game, the effort was there, just fine-tune it. We need to play with the same pace. Our forwards and our D have to play at the same speed and kind of thought process, and eliminate turnovers and bury some opportunities. We had some really good opportunities last night that, Bersani, Storjan, and Wickline line had a couple, and I know Petro had a couple that he didn't bury, and, you know, if we do that, it's a different game.
All right, boom, thanks for joining us. Best of luck tonight.
You bet, thank you.
Back with a drop of the puck in just a moment. This is River Dragons Hockey.
Winter is upon us. We must prepare. Cold and darkness will spread across the land. The nights will be long.
Hey, what are you guys doing? Air Force is here to fix the heat.
Don't let winter leave you out in the cold. Call Air Force Heating and Air now for our special $79 AC gas furnace or heat pump tune-up, only for a limited time. Air Force Heating and Air is always here for you.
We all dream, but dreams quickly become distant memories unless we do something about it. Do everything in our power to learn to lead. At Troy University, we teach everyone to be leaders in their field. We're dedicated to teaching a new generation to lead change.
Even though I'm away at college, Kinetic Credit Union is still the best way for me to stay connected here and at home. With the Kinetic mobile app, I have control of my accounts wherever I go. I can easily transfer money between internal and external accounts, get money faster by setting up recurring transfers, and I can find the nearest ATM or branch right from my phone. Plus, I can add my Kinetic cards to my phone's digital wallet and enjoy quick, secure, contactless payments. By the way, Mom, I need some more money.
Kinetic Credit Union, the energy for your dreams.
Comes, boys.
Sure is beautiful.
Here it is, boys. Who's ready to put it to work?
Me? There's only one way to settle this.
Rock.
Where'd he come from?
I win. Never saw him coming.
Must be the camo.
Drive off in a new John Deere from SunSouth right now with 0% financing on select models. SunSouth, equipment for those that do.
You're in luck, pull your car or truck into Zelmo's, Zelmo's, Zelmo's.
This month at Zelmo's, all Celsius energy drinks, 2 for $4.
But you're in luck, pull your car or truck into Zelmo's, Zelmo's, Zelmo's.
Always clean, always fast, always friendly. Zelmo's Zip-In, fueling life's passions for 20 years.
On the network for station identification.
You're listening to River Dragons Hockey on WKCN HD2 Fort Moore, Columbus, and W295 AY Crystal Valley. 106.9 really rocks.
Okay, now let's get to our starting goaltenders here now that we have legalized everything. Starting in goal tonight for the Columbus River Dragons, it is Taylor Joseph getting the nod in net. I can't believe he gave up a broadcast career to go back and play hockey, but he did. 9-1-0-1 with a .908 save percentage and a 2.45 goals against, along with a shutout on the season. For the second straight night, it's Blake Wyrick in net for the Seawolves, 4-3-0-1 with a 2.71 goals against and a .933 save percentage. So River Dragons getting ready to go here head-to-head with the Seawolves as the introductions have finished down on the ice. And I believe we're about ready to get our moment of silence and national anthem underway. After that, we'll have the referee introductions, which are brought to you by the Optical Shop. Well, we'll get to that in just a moment. Down to the ice we go.
Ladies and gentlemen, at this time, we ask that you please rise and remove your caps for the singing of our national anthem, sponsored by America's Thrift Store. Singing our national anthem tonight is Brad Day.
Oh, say, can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the pale sky, or the ramparts we watched were still gallantly streaming. And the rockets regular, the bombs bursting in air, caper through the night that our flag was still there. Oh,
all right, anthem in the books before tonight's game, and we are getting ready to go here in just a moment. I want to remind everybody of your next Eat with the Dragons event is coming up this Sunday, and it's going to be at Chef Lee's at 6100 Bradley Park Drive at 6 o'clock. Team dinner over there. All players will be there for pictures, for autographs, and a chance to meet the guys, chat a little bit with them. That's at Chef Lee's, 6100 Bradley Park Drive, 6 o'clock. And again, that is March 10th, so that is coming up here on the weekend. Want to make sure everybody is aware of that. The River Dragons are playing 3-3. Tonight is game number two. They played last night. We'll play Friday at home against the Carolina Thunderbirds. That's a 7:35 puck drop on Sensory Awareness Night. And then no game Saturday, Sunday, because that would be cruel. So Columbus will get a couple of days there to rest, and then we will be at that team dinner March 10th at Chef Lee's restaurant at 6 o'clock. So we hope you're able to come down and join us for that. We'll get to our referee introductions here in just a moment. Again, brought to you by the Optical Shop. But it's time to drop the puck, and the River Dragons are going to roll right to left in front of our broadcast location in the white jerseys. And Kuznetsov is just wandering away from the faceoff circle now for some reason over to the bench, and I'm not sure why. He's actually leaving the ice. Boy, I hope Kuznetsov is all right. He was not moving fast when he went to the bench. That is unusual. I'm not sure. Kuznetsov is still standing up and kind of moving side to side. The trainer is working on him right now. Boy, that was just kind of an odd occurrence. We'll keep an eye on number 22. Puck is in the River Dragon zone to start things out here, and Joseph almost gave it away on the near side. Required a diving block by the defenseman there to get him out of trouble. Shinkarik will go the other way for Columbus and fire it right through the goal crease out the other side. Anderson down from the left point to keep it in. As the puck escapes out to center, it is Wicklein, Bersani, and Storjahan starting things off here. And the River Dragons trying to move up on the forecheck here. Puck past Shinkarik, pinching from the right point down. It goes Bersani after it. Now Storjahan on the left side. We'll dump it on in. River Dragons will change it up as well. Not quite a minute into this hockey game. And the Seawolves on the regroup here. They're wearing the blue uniforms here tonight. As that pass missed and ends up as an icing call as Underwood beats Nielsen back to the puck. 59 seconds into the opening frame. Kind of checking over there for Kuznetsov on the bench. He's now just sitting and the trainer is no longer working on him. But boy, that was a moment there. I was a little worried for him the way he went off the ice pretty slowly. Looks like he's all right. Jemayev is going to circle out here. The referees are actually talking right now here. Not sure about what. I don't know if there would be anything like a minor or something ensuing that the player couldn't start. Obviously, it was an injury situation. So I wonder if they kind of give him a pass. But a lot of times, you have to start with the players that are on your sheet to start the game. I don't know if they would go so far as to issue a minor penalty here. And I'll be honest with you, even if that is the case where they're supposed to issue a minor penalty, I would probably give the Seawolves a pass on this one. So anyway, while we've got a moment here, why don't we talk about your referees tonight. Brought to you by the Optical Shop in Phoenix City, where right now Just $99 in a bag of chips will get you two pair of eyeglasses. You should see the game they're missing. Your referees tonight are number 27, Dave Glassman, and number 18, Chris Rowe. Your linesman, number 80, Gary Glassman, and number 18, Jonathan DeSale. Guess what? The Seawolves are getting a penalty. And I'm pretty sure it is for an improper starting lineup. Letter of the law, this one would be correct. So this is the, believe it or not, the River Dragons didn't even have a power play last night. This is their first power play, and it's 59 seconds into the first period. And they're going to have somebody go in and serve it. I think it's Kuznetsov who does go in to serve the penalty. Or the penalty is against Kuznetsov here. I'm not even sure if he was able to get to the box to serve it. But anyway, we'll get the call in a moment. River Dragons to the man advantage here. There's a shot coming in and a diving block on that Austin Doe attempt, and it's bounced out of the zone. So it is Kuznetsov for delay of game is how they term it. But I'm pretty sure that is because of that open there. So the River Dragons on the Loft Power Play. The Loft features live music every Friday and Saturday night. Show your River Dragons ticket stub for a two-for-one deal on cover. Yes, the River Dragons push in again. The five out as Moore will put it up top to Doe over to the left point. Storjahan down the left side wall, switching with Petrantonio. Top of the near circle, Petrantonio's wrister missed the net. Round to the far side, McDonald on the puck. McDonald up top to Doe. Doe, cross ice, looking for Petrantonio. Pass deflected, he'll bank it back up top. Left point, Doe. Doe, McDonald, he'll switch with him. Left side, half wall, Petrantonio. Slides it into the slot, a backhand try, save made, and no rebound there as Weirich eats it up. He'll hold on for a draw to his right. River Dragons will change up the power play unit here. 2:06 into the first period. So Columbus now will come out with Jemayev, Wickline, Slahetka, Shinkarik, and Hunter. Draw to the right of the Seawolves net, push back towards the point. Shinkarik will move to his right across the blue line. Back to the near dot, Slahetka. Wrist shot, missed the net. That puck, well, hit the referee in the corner. Wickline trying to get over there. He and Barr tied up. Jemayev in the pile. He's bodied off it. Up top here, Slahetka. Shinkarik back towards Slahetka. But in space, it's cleared out now. And Hunter has to go back after. A little hesitation there from the River Dragon. Shinkarik took a pass off his skate, kicked it all the way down low behind the Columbus net. Hunter up the right side, gets it to Shinkarik. He'll carry it over the line, leaving off on the right wing side. Columbus back in to set up. Wickline hooks it up top. Slahetka, right point, over to the left side. Shinkarik, they'll switch. Shinkarik through traffic, save made, and the rebound in front just past Jemayev, diving at the line. River Dragons keep it in. Nice job by Shinkarik. Into the near side corner, Wickline, left half wall. Slahetka, time ticking down, power plays over. Shinkarik, a shot blocked by Anderson. Now he hooks it on goal, save made on that Wickline attempt, and quickly snapping the puck up with the blocking glove is Blake Weirich. That one is reminiscent of the old Dominic Hasek grab it and hang on maneuver. So the River Dragons 0-for-1 on the power play. And again, I mean, we had a sluggish start to yesterday's game, and this game appears to be no different so far to start things off here. Faceoff will be to the right of the Seawolves' goal. And they will control up the left side. Bond moving it ahead, but he coughed it up at center. Here's Bonkwell stepping up. He'll pitch that one down low. Nathan Bockwell got his first professional goal last night in the game. Congratulations to him. Mississippi able to move it out. Here's Nielsen at center. Lead pass a little too far ahead for Bond. Behind the net, Bond after it. Storjahan will take it away, move it up the far side. Bersani pushed it back into the corner. Wrapped it back around to the near wing. Down for the right point, keeping it in is Russell. Russell tying it up on the half wall. Swan over there after it. Swan in for Andreoli here tonight for the River Dragons. That's pushed up the wall. And out to center. Ryan Gill also scratched tonight for Columbus. Russell all the way back in his own end. He'll feed it over the left side to Lind. 4 minutes into the first. No score here. Up the right side off the boards. River Dragons trying to poke it back the other way here. Bockwell. Up the wing, Bersani chasing it into the left side corner. Lind Tried to reverse it. Didn't get it very far, but now it's cleared to the line, and Duncan cannot keep it in. Is arriving on the change there. Puck tied up as it drifts to center. And now Mississippi will once again regroup in their own end. Lynn with a feed that hit Moore. Now it's turned in from there. Joseph out to stop it behind the goal. He'll leave force Lahetka, who's pressured on the forecheck. Gets it around towards Hunter. Hunter trying to catch up with it. Pokes it up the wall. And, well, it did not come out. Looked like it did. Now the puck floats over to the near side. Columbus trying to clear it out off the glass here. Still not out of there. It's Lahetka leaving it in space. Here's Duncan. Duncan with a little wedge out to center. A bouncer that gets through. Here's Hunter on the right side. But the bouncing puck eludes him as well. He has to go back to the corner for it. Tied up on the wall. Stoya can't clear. McDonald hooks it in front. Kyle Moore all alone. Deke shoots. Scores! Kyle Moore was all by himself. The D had gotten caught up in the play. Moore was alone in the slot. Great feed to him. And Moore goes backhand, forehand, hooks it around the left pad of the goaltender Weirich, and it's 1-0 River Dragons. Also, guess what? 31 games with a point for Justin McDonald now, as he'll pick up an assist on that goal. The streak continues, 5:08 into the first period. McDonald and Hunter, the assists on the goal. And Columbus once again strikes first with an even strength marker. And for Kyle Moore, that will be his 21st goal of the season. Boy, McDonald's vision is just incredible. The way he was able to find Moore down there and icing coming up against Columbus. I'm sure that Moore was calling for the puck, but just an absolute fantastic pass. And then Moore, of course, has to finish. He's in tight with zero speed. But he finds a way to finish and get the job done. So, all right, time to take a media timeout. We will grab our first break of the period. 5:26 into the opening frame. River Dragons have opened up a 1-0 lead over the Mississippi Seawolves. Back on the war in a moment on River Dragons Hockey.
Hello there. My name is Seychelle, and what makes the Chick-fil-A chicken sandwich original to me is that punch of flavors that's unlike any other. You get the crispy tenderness of the chicken and that hint of sourness from the pickles. Ta-da!
Hey, I'm Juan, and what makes the Chick-fil-A chicken sandwich original to me is every single time you take a bite, you know you're gonna get chicken that's crispy, golden, and juicy. The Chick-fil-A chicken sandwich is the gold standard of chicken sandwiches. There's no touching it.
Good internet. Get upfront surprise-free pricing with Wi-Fi modem included and no data caps. Plus bundle internet 300 with YouTube TV for just $92.99 per month for 12 months with autopay and paperless billing.
Wow. What? Tim Hortons has a new $6 breakfast bundle? With a mouthwatering breakfast sandwich, a golden hash brown with a small hot or iced coffee, and a classic donut made for your me time. Oh, and yours too. The $6 breakfast bundle at your neighborhood.
And we are back on River Dragons Hockey. This first period is presented by Chick-fil-A Midland. And our next Eat with the River Dragons event at Chick-fil-A Midlands coming up Tuesday, March 26th from 6 to 7 p.m. Come eat with the team, get autographs, pictures, and more. That's only at Chick-fil-A Midland Tuesday, March 26th from 6 to 7 p.m. Face-off coming up to the right of Taylor Joseph in the River Dragons net, who hasn't seen a shot on goal yet. That could change here, but Russell's attempt block came back to him. Another chance deflected wide of the net. River Dragons able to wedge that one out through center, and now Jamanth will pick it up on the right side, him with a long wrister. That one deflects off the mid of Weirich and behind the net. Down for the left point, Duncan able to keep it alive. Barr in the corner, trying to take it away. Doe back towards Jamanth, who swings it around the rim to the right point. Anderson on the backhand keeps it in as he sends it back deep. Glove down in front by Doe. His shot tipped off a body out of play. Not quite 6 minutes into this first period. 1-0 River Dragons. Kyle Moore the goal with the assist going to Ryan Hunter and Justin McDonald. Now 31 straight with a point for J-Mac. 70 points in that stretch. And now he's to 60 assists. That leads the league. Leads the league in quite a few categories. Is the scoring leader in the league right now. River Dragons control the offensive zone draw. Right center Storjahan of the cycle, wanted Wickline to the slot, fed it behind him. cleared up the wall towards the point, and that'll be moved out by Nielsen. Here's Bond up the left side. Shakarik pacing him. Long shot in, waved at by the blocker of Joseph as it goes wide. Bond onto the near side, knocked down over there. Penalty coming up against Shinkarik. We finally get the whistle here. Shinkarik's going to go to the box for cross-checking. He's not excited about that, but I don't find too many players who really say, you know what, I deserve that penalty. Yes, I should go sit. So the Seawolves on to their first power play of the night. They were 0-for-1 last night with the only power play of the game going to Mississippi. So already tonight we've got more power plays than we saw the entirety of the game yesterday. Shinkarik into the Abercrombie bonding penalty box where the River Dragons will try to spring him as soon as they can here. 2 minutes from now. Seawolves power play 22.6. That is fourth in the league. And we get a whistle here. The puck outside the zone. We get a face-off outside the line. Columbus's kill is first in the FPHL, 86.6, and continues to improve, believe it or not. With the River Dragons, I know that Coach Bichard said, I'd like a 90 or a 95%. And you think he might be kidding. He's not. He would like it to be 90 or 95%. But 86.6 at this point in the year, pretty darn good. Hooked down the ice by Bersani off that faceoff just outside the River Dragons end of things. And now back down after Mississippi will regroup here on the power play. Up the left side, Bond will feed it up ahead of the line, tipped on but didn't get back to Bond. Swan off the glass down the ice. And I'll tell you what, Swan, looks like he took a shot there. He's complaining to the ref and looks like the left arm hurt him a little bit there. Didn't quite see what happened, but back comes Bond in on the left side for Mississippi. Underwood on him, behind the net, Bockwell also closing it off. Underwood tried to leave it back side of the net, Bond with it with a chance right across the goal mouth. Up to the right point it goes. Aslan holding it in there. He'll feed on to the right wing corner, now fed up top Stoya. Stoya, wrister, blocked, puck at the line, and Swan can't battle it out of there. Aslan feeds it down low. Bond looking in front. Chance on the back door and a left pad save there by Joseph. Puck is cleared off a stanchion and does just get between two Seawolves defenders and out. 38 seconds to go on the power play. 1-0 River Dragons here. As we are coming up on the 8-minute mark of this opening frame, shots still remain 3-0. They did not give credit to Joseph for a save on that one. Stoya on the left side, puck in the left wing corner. Barr putting it back to the left point because net's off. Back to the left half wall. And now another penalty coming up against the River Dragons. Here's Stoya to the near dot. A chance for Anderson. His shot is blocked into the corner. And with 10 seconds to go in Shinkarik's call, there's going to be a high sticking call against Slahetka. So the River Dragons have 2D in the penalty box. And 10 seconds of 5-on-3 with a faceoff coming up. So this will be a huge, huge draw win if the River Dragons get it. 8:13 time of the penalty. Boy, you hope tonight doesn't turn into a parade to the box, that's for sure. Faceoff coming up to the right of Taylor Joseph. And it's won back by Mississippi. They will control here. Moved over to the right side. It's Nielsen. Onto the right wing. Looking in front here. Anderson, a shot. That is blocked. Petrantonio backhands it down the ice. Justice Shinkarik onto there. He will step up and apply pressure here. Weirich's got to play it around to the far side. But, boy, Columbus, I'll tell you what, able to get that puck out and not let Mississippi keep the pressure on. That was pretty important right there. So now the second power play of the game with Slahetka in the Abercrombie bonding penalty box right after they got Carter Shinkarik out of there. 1:20 to go on the man advantage here. Underwood springs it onto the far side. Petrantonio over there with it. He'll send it on down. A bouncer just wide of the Seawolves net. Now pushing up on the left side is Austin Doe. Doe trying to rag the puck behind the net as he's tied up. Still with it in the corner though. And now it's jarred free, ends up with Russell behind the net, and Doe will head for the change. Mississippi at center. Russell leaves it back for Bond. Left side in. Here's Portillo into the slot. Bond drifting to his left. A wrister. Save made Joseph. And that one to the point. And one-handed out of there by McDonald. Sent back, and Portillo missed the pass there. Ends up with Anderson. Hugh Anderson will just bank it out over the line. Seawolves have to reset here. And now it's stolen away. And here's Shinkarik pushing up shorthanded. Carter Shinkarik trying to work his way in. Aslan swept it off his stick to the corner. 24 seconds to go on the man advantage. Seawolves looking to leave the zone here. Pass ahead, hit Portillo in the skates. But now Wong on the left side. Across for Bond in behind the D. Into the forehand. He scores. Jackson Bond faked the deke to the backhand, kept it on the forehand, and Joseph would have made the save, but unfortunately he was traveling backwards so quickly his left pad went into the net, the puck went in with it, and Bond scores the goal to tie things up. 9:59 time of the goal. So that will make it a power play marker. And for Bond, that's his 14th of the year. Seawolves now 1-for-2 on the power play.
Seawolves power play goal! Score by number 43, Jackson Bond! Assisted by number 10, Philip Wong! And by number 4, Matt Stoy!
So halfway through this first period, we are now tied at one. We're going to get to a break and come back with more in just a moment. Stay tuned. More of the Chick-fil-A Midland first period coming your way in a moment on River Dragons Hockey.
Hey, y'all. My name is Tiara, and a little thing that I love about the Chick-fil-A spicy chicken biscuit is that it has the perfect amount of spice to jumpstart my day. I just love how the biscuit just matches perfectly with the spice on the chicken filet. Whoever thought of it, thank you so much.
Hi, my name is Robert, and a little thing I love about Chick-fil-A's spicy chicken biscuit is the biscuit. It reminds me of my grandma's homemade biscuit. It's always buttery and savory. The chicken is always crispy. Then you add the spices to the chicken. Instant classic.
Hi-ho, hi-ho, your gas is getting low. But you're in luck, pull your car or truck into Zelmo's, Zelmo's, Zelmo's.
This month at Zelmo's, all Celsius energy drinks, 2 for $4.
But you're in luck, pull your car or truck into Zelmo's, Zelmo's, Zelmo's.
Always clean, always fast, always friendly. Zelmo's Zip-In, fueling life's passions for 20 years.
Back here in the Chick-fil-A Midland first period. It's a 1-1 tie now. Just past the halfway mark here. Jackson Bond with a power play goal to tie it up after Kyle Moore opened the scoring. Faceoff will be to the left of Blake Wyrick in the Seawolves net. And they're going to... Nope. All right, McDonald just went for a circle. He was not getting tossed out of the draw. Faceoff here to left of Seawolves net eventually as Helland and Hunter both kind of ease in early. I guess we'll go to it at some point here, but... Moore is stationed to the left and at the top of the circle behind McDonald, who's going to try to win this draw back to him there. They tie it up, and the Seawolves actually win the draw. Lind around to the near side. It ends up at the left point, and Duncan is hit by Helland there. The puck stayed in momentarily. Helland now to the line with it. Does get it ahead, but the pass missed Barr. Now a race, and that will be icing. Slahetka back after it, and now we get some chopping with Helland in behind the play. Duncan's going to go over there. Let Lucas Helland doing what he does best. And now Aslan grabbing a River Dragon in front of the bench. Linesman get in there. It's actually Ryan Hunter he's tangled up with. That would be a good trade for the Seawolves, I'll tell you what, if you get Ryan Hunter off the ice. It looks like Aslan may be going, and he is. I don't know if Hunter's going to go as well. But David Aslan is into the box. for the Seawolves. .10:25 time of the penalty here. And so the River Dragons look like they are indeed going back onto the Loft power play. The Loft has live music every Friday and Saturday night. Show your River Dragons ticket stub for a 2-for-1 deal on cover. Only at the Loft in downtown Columbus. And so the River Dragons back to the man advantage here. They're 0-for-1. Power play ranked third coming into the game at 28.1%. Seventh on the kill for the Seawolves at 77.4%. Interestingly enough, it has been the Seawolves with the power play goal here in this first period. With the game tied up here at 1. Columbus is going to start with Bersani. Well, actually, you know what? I think Aslan just got a 10. Scratch that. No power play. I think Aslan just earned himself a 10-minute misconduct. Or at least there's nothing on the clock yet. The referee's still over at the Seawolves bench. But there are 5 Seawolves players on the ice. So no power play for the River Dragons. All right, just a 10-minute misconduct, it looks like. So, 5-on-5, we continue. With the game tied at 1, River Dragons will only have that one power play earlier then, but they do keep the puck in. There's a shot, hit a body in front, caroms to the near side. Mississippi able to clear it out. Helen skips through a check. Puck ends up back with Storjahan. He'll leave it off, and now up the near side wall. It's played ahead. Duncan with a pass. Storjahan to the right side, moving in on the backhand, leaving it up top. Russell trying to chop it away from Wickline. It curls up the wall. He wanted to center. Kuznetsov on him. Kuznetsov ends up with the puck. He'll move it away on the right wing side. That'll be dumped in by Lambert. River Dragons on the regroup. Little wedge out to center here. Stoya backing up on it. Sit back across here. Slahetka. Slahetka leading the charge right side. He's all by himself. Tries to walk around the D. Gets through. Puck went behind the net. He centers. There's nobody there. Right pointer's Doe coming into the play. Throws it on goal. Blocker saved there by Shepard. Near side, Petrantonio trying to push it free. Left point, Bockwell keeps it in. Jemayev loops up top of it, banks it right back around. Petrantonio on the near wall. He'll send it towards the front of the net. Doe tried to kick it along to Jemayev, almost worked out. Puck to the line, not out. Kept in, quick shot coming in, and the save. Weirich, no rebound. He'll hold on with 8:15 to go in the first. Game remains tied at 1. So Columbus here trying to push the advantage a little bit. They keep Jemayev, Doe, Petrantonio out there. They had some pretty good pressure there. Bockwell and Underwood face off to the right of the Seawolves net. Push behind the net towards Lind. Lind up the left side for Mississippi, and that missed on the pass. Will it be icing? No, they wave it off, so Joseph out to play it. Scoops it ahead. Here's Doe getting it right back on the pass. And now in behind the play, Joseph is going to pick up a tripping call as he got tangled up with Wong. Joseph's goal stick ended up in the high slot area. They're going to call interference against Taylor Joseph. I do not like the way this game is going for the River Dragons. Jemayev is going to head into the Abercrombie bonding penalty box to serve for Taylor Joseph. Seawolves 1-for-2 on the power play already to their third chance of the period. There's a number of things, boy, I could just kind of hear inside the head of Jerome Bichard right now. The team is a little sluggish with some fits and starts of energy and chances, but the other thing is they're just not playing a crisp attention to detail game right now. The detail is definitely lacking. And now they're shorthanded again. They do start with a clear, and thankfully the kill is as good as it is, but even that said, they did give up a power play goal earlier. Columbus, for some reason, obviously didn't really have it yesterday, but still came out with the win. Thought maybe, it's a little bit of bus legs and just a sluggish game. It's a Wednesday, you know, not a lot of atmosphere, but nope, they're kind of right back at it again here tonight, Columbus. Except the Seawolves are playing at a slightly higher level than they did yesterday. Yesterday was 3-1 Columbus, but right now Mississippi has been, for the balance of the first, the better team. Stoyan gets over to the left side. He'll put it across looking for Wong, but that pass is intercepted, cleared down by Columbus. 1:10 to go on the man advantage. 7:03 and counting to go in the first, tied at one. Shots are 6-3 in favor of the River Dragons. Mississippi on the regroup. Wong will dump that one in from center. Joseph out behind the net. He'll play it along past Anderson. Up to the right point. Stoya keeping it in, though. Puck bouncing in front is cleared. And just past the reach of Stoya. Out it goes. And now a race. Stoya will just beat Bersani back to the biscuit. And turn to center now. Up on the left side. Here's Anderson moving it in on the wing. And he takes a wrist shot that misses on the glove side. But wraps its way all the way back to Shinkarik at his own line. Shinkarik, though, backed up without it. Had to feed it across quickly to Anderson. He will send it back down. And 27 seconds to go on the power play for the Seawolves. Bersani, pesky on the forecheck behind the net. Puck swung away to the right side, Nielsen. Bersani now goes after as well. Has to loop back inside his own blue line. Nielsen will try the left side on the backhand. Walks in over the line. Nielsen knocked out over there, and no call coming. Puck free to the near side. Chipped off the glass ahead, and now a chance shorthanded up the left side of your Sequoia Swan. He's got an angle in with a wrist shot. Hit the goal post. Sequoia Swan rang it off the iron. Back the other way, Anderson will throw that one in. Power play is over. Out of the Abercrombie bonding penalty box is Jemayev serving that interference call against Joseph. And now 1-for-3 for the Seawolves with the man advantage. That was actually a much better last half of that kill for Columbus. They actually brought their own energy up with it. Boy, Sequoia Swan just inches from giving his team the lead. Seawolves on the right side of the offensive zone. Mississippi trying to set it up, but Columbus able to clear. River Dragons looking to reset the lines here. Storjahan up front with Wickline and Jemayev out there right now. Puck is cleared ahead. Lissio reaching for it, had it tapped away. Wickline on the far side, tied up in front of the Seawolves bench. Lead for Bond. Bond scoots his way through traffic. He's pulled down. No call coming. And now back the other way, the lead too far for Storjahan, rolled away from him. Lissio pushing back in on the wing. Duncan trying to clear it out. Puck in his skates. Wickline looking to help out. At the point, Wong holding on. Nielsen to the backhand. Doesn't let a shot go. He'll feed it behind the net. Far side corner, Lissio after it. 4:44 to go in the first, tied at one. Wickline in the pile over there. And it's cleared into the slot. Storjahan can't move it out, but McDonald does. McDonald tried to feed it ahead, pass deflected back. Bond will dump it into the River Dragons bench. We'll get a whistle and a break. 4:27 to go in the first. Tied at one. Back with more in a moment. First period brought to you by Chick-fil-A Midland on River Dragons Hockey.
I Spice?
Wait, who's that?
It's my ex, Lemon Lime Soda.
You're looking well.
I just needed something more refreshing, more crisp. I'm with Starry now.
This is intense.
He's so vulnerable.
But I love you. Please.
Ah, buddy, it'll be okay.
Or not.
Huh, Starry does taste better.
Hey, y'all. My name is Tiara, and a little thing that I love about the Chick-fil-A spicy chicken biscuit is that it has the perfect amount of spice to jumpstart my day. I just love how the biscuit just matches perfectly with the spice on the chicken filet. Whoever thought of it, thank you so much.
Hi, my name is Robert, and the little thing I love about Chick-fil-A's spicy chicken biscuit is the biscuit. It reminds me of my grandma's homemade biscuit. It's always buttery and savory. The chicken is always crispy. Then you add the spices to the chicken. Instant classic.
Bringing East Alabama more. It's in our name.
And we are back here at the Mississippi Gulf Coast Coliseum. 4:27 to go in the first, tied at one. Kyle Moore for the River Dragons. Jackson Bond for the Seawolves. Shots are 8-3 in favor of Columbus. And Sequoia Swan hit a goal post and a shorthanded chance. River Dragons Again, a bit of a sluggish first period here, trying to shake that off, hopefully, in the next four and a half before we get to the intermission. Draw right on the dot at center, and Columbus will move it ahead. Here's a chance on the right side. Moore moving in front, looking for Hunter. He was hooked up, couldn't get a shot away. Hunter around to the left point, kept in by Bothwell. Went off Moore into the corner. And now it's cleared back up top off Kuznetsov out of the zone. Bockwell pokes it across. River Dragons flip it back in, looking for McDonald in the slot. Pass didn't get to him. Kuznetsov cut it off, but Hunter steals it back at the line. Now he'll walk in offside. McDonald was trying to get out of the zone. Hunter, a little anxious to get in there. That offside brought to you by Old School Barbershop. They're online at Old School Barber, SHOPPE.com. Your sides are a little off. Get lined up at Old School Barbershop. Reservations highly recommended. You can book online anytime at oldschoolbarbershop.com or 24/7 through their Instagram and their Facebook. Face off just outside the blue line. Mississippi will work it back. They'll try to move it up the boards. Anderson after the puck. He'll move it across. And in the River Drag, give it up in the slot there. Lissio, though, was converged on quickly by a couple of white jerseys and now pushing ahead. Here's Shinkarik. Shinkarik lost it at the line, though. Has to go back to center for it. Hooks it in. River Dragons tag up. Petrantonio up on the forecheck here as it's set up behind the net. Russell surveying the landscape. Looks out the right side. Lifts a pass off the glass. It's cut off at center by Anderson. Ends up back with Portillo, though. Seawolves push on. Left side, Portillo into the zone. Ends up backhanding it behind the net. 3:15 to go here in the first. Jamath after it, and he'll start up the slot. Move through center with Mississippi changing his pass, deflected into the River Dragons bench. So we get a whistle here, and our first period intermission guest will be Josh Petrantonio. The captain will be joining us here tonight, so stay tuned for that. Coming up in our SunSouth John Deere first intermission report. River Dragons Hockey is also brought to you in part by BKI Accounting, a new age approach to old school accounting. They specialize in payroll, bookkeeping, income, and sales taxes for small business. Learn more at bkiaccounting.com. Seawolves control the faceoff, and they'll look up the left side. Puck tipped in, Wong up on the forecheck after it, left wing corner. On the left side wall, Bond sends it in front. Nielsen had a stick tied up, couldn't get a shot away. And now the River Dragons attack the left side. Up by himself is Wickline, leaving it into space. Orjahan tried to jam it across. Bersani picks it up off the dasher right side. Cycles it for Orjahan, moving in the high slot. Orjahan, right side, works it around the wall. Puck behind the net. Stoya tried to leave it off, but he put it right to Bersani. Bersani on the backhand far side. A quick shot, save made, rebound, right back into the gear of Shepard and just out the other side. And it's cleared to center, Wyrick, not Shepard, rather. Left side moving in is Storjahan. He's hooked up, trying to get after the puck. Boy, Blake Wyrick there with a hairy moment. Got enough of it as he scrambled to his right. The puck actually escaped out the other side, but, hey, didn't cross the line. There's a lead ahead. Now Bond with a stretch, but the puck rolled off a stick onto the left side. He'll go all the way behind the net. Jackson Bond up the near side, put it into the slot, but that's just a turnover. As Columbus moving ahead on the right wing side. And now Moore leaving it for Hunter behind the net. Back after it, Aslan poked it right to McDonald. McDonald rolled it into the crease, and Wyrick will just pounce on that and hang on. 1:41 to go here in the first, tied at one. Shots now 11-3 in favor of the River Dragons. I'll be honest with you, I don't think that's entirely accurate. I feel like Mississippi has more than that. Face-off will be to the left of the Seawolves' net. McDonald, Moore, Hunter out up front. Bockwell and Underwood on the points. One back by Mississippi. And they will clear it to the line. Out to center it goes after the hit delivered there by Hunter. Underwood back after it. Moore tips a pass on in space. Aslan moving it back towards Lind. Lind trying the far side. He'll skate to center. Lind all the way into the zone, chips into the corner, go gets it, sends it behind the net, but right to Bockwell, who backhands it around, but it hit the glass, and it's turned over in front for a goal. A bad bounce against the River Dragons there leads to a Seawolves goal with just 1:13 left to go in the period. Mississippi capitalizes, and they grab the lead. See if the River Dragons have a response here on the shift after the goal. They're trying to push ahead. Lucas Helen gets credit for the goal. Icing. As Lind, the assist on the goal. Icing will put the faceoff back into the Seawolves' end. Just the fourth of the year for Lucas Helen. Two-one your score. Mississippi in the lead here. 53.9 seconds left to go in the period. Looks like they're fixing the time on the clock. Should be more like 56 seconds. Maybe they're just going to hold the clock here for a couple seconds. Face-off is dropped. Puck ends up in the near side. Here's Petrantonio sending into the slot for a chance, and that one is just healed wide by Shinkarik as he's tried to sneak down the wing, and the puck is cleared out. Anderson all the way back after it. 40 seconds to go in the frame now. Anderson pressured here by Dalton Anderson from Mississippi. Petrantonio with a bank pass ahead looking for Jemayev. Couldn't get it to him. And now Shinkarik will try to move it ahead. 29 seconds to go in the period. Shinkarik tried to walk the D and had it poked away. Puck cleared back out. 20 seconds to go. Columbus is going to have to hurry if they want to do something off this rush. They're actually changing personnel. That forces Anderson to stop. Now go up the left side. Turned over to Wong. Wong back to Bond. Bond trying to walk through. He's in on goal to the backhand. Lost the handle. Puck into the slot again. A chance. Time winding down. Wong a backhand blocked. Into the corner it goes. And there's the horn. Not a good period for the Columbus River Dragons. Not a good period at all. They will need a better effort than that in the next 40 minutes if they want to beat Mississippi tonight. And they definitely have it in them. And now they have an intermission to regroup. Hopefully they use it to do just that. And right now Ryan Hunter is talking to the referee here at center. But boy, I'll tell you what, Columbus for the second night in a row, a bit of a slow start. Last night it didn't bite them. Tonight it has bitten them not once but twice. And sure, a bit of a fortunate break for the Mississippi Seawolves that they were able to get that late turnover and stick it in the net. But, and you got to credit the Seawolves for being right place, right time, and, you know, pushing in and making that happen. So for Columbus, they have 40 minutes to go. And, you know, what a team that's done so well all season long. And I understand, you know, not every game is your best game. But, again, just going to kind of keep the old fingers crossed here that the River Dragons have something in the tank for period numbers 2 and 3. And don't forget, tomorrow night we're back home against Carolina as well. So right now Columbus down 2-1 after one. And when we come back, we're going to hear from the captain, Josh Petrantonio. So stay tuned for that, as Columbus do have some good news here. The streak continues for Justin McDonald. He picks up an assist on Kyle Moore's goal here in the first period. So now 31 games with a point. The league record streak is extended for J-Mac. All right, 2-1 Mississippi after one. Back with the Sun South John Deere first period intermission report in just a moment. This is Columbus River Dragons hockey.
Here he comes, boys.
Sure is beautiful.
Here it is, boys. Who's ready to put it to work?
Me.
There's only one way to settle this.
Where'd he come from?
I win. Never saw him coming.
Must be the camo.
Drive off in a new John Deere from SunSouth right now with 0% financing on select models. SunSouth, equipment for those that do.
We all dream, but dreams quickly become distant memories unless we do something about it. Do everything in our power to learn to lead. At Troy University, we teach everyone to be leaders in their field. We're dedicated to teaching a new generation to lead change.
Tim Hortons has a new $6 breakfast bundle with a mouthwatering breakfast sandwich, a golden hash brown with a small hot or iced coffee, and a classic donut made for your me time. Oh, and yours too. The $6 breakfast bundle at your neighborhood Tim's.
Just the two of us. We can make it if we try. Just the two of us.
Get two entrees and an appetizer for $25 only at Applebee's.
Hi-ho, hi-ho, your gas is getting low. But you're in luck, pull your car or truck into Zelmo's, Zelmo's, Zelmo's.
This month at Zelmo's, all Celsius energy drinks, 2 for $4.
But you're in luck, pull your car or truck into Zelmo's, Zelmo's, Zelmo's.
Always clean, always fast, always friendly. Zelmo's Zip-In, fueling life's passions for 20 years.
Welcome back to the Sun-South John Deere First Period Intermission Report, joined by Captain Josh Petrantonio. Petro, big win for this team here last night. Kind of an awkward week. You come in starting on a Wednesday night here, but that went a little closer than most games against Mississippi. Take us through that 60 minutes.
Yeah, you know what? I mean, struggled a little bit getting off the bus. Obviously, no excuses. We just got to be better overall. We were a little bit sloppy. Boomer hit the nail on the head this morning. He said we were playing a little bit fast. Sometimes we need to just slow down and make sure we're all coming out as a unit.
You know, it's interesting. We do talk a lot about River Dragons hockey and the things you want to do and the steps kind of at this time of year that you're going over. But what are some of the things you're hammering home right now?
Just control the blue lines. Obviously, get pucks out at our blue line and get pucks deep at the other team's blue line. Just making sure we're controlling those areas and winning the battles in those areas and everything else to take care of itself. I mean, our team is so deep. We've got so much creativity, so much speed, so much physicality that if we just focus on those areas, the rest of it will take care of itself.
I feel like Mississippi is a pretty good case in point when we talk about teams. If you let them hang around, they could be dangerous towards the end of the game, and that's what happened yesterday.
Yeah, obviously their goalie played really well. He made a lot of big saves. I think for us it was just, we were just kind of out of sync, you know. A lot of the game was played maybe one or two guys rather than a five-man unit out there, and we just got to be better at controlling the game and kind of playing as a unit.
What are some of the things then that you would circle as important for tonight as far as having a bounce back effort and being a little better out there?
I mean, just taking a step back, getting back to what we're used to, getting back to the way we normally play and making sure we're all on the same page. D-zone, moving through the neutral zone into the offensive zone.
All right, Josh, thanks for joining us. Best of luck out there.
Thanks, Kelly.
Back with more of the First Period Intermission Report in just a moment.
Here he comes, boys.
Sure is beautiful.
Here it is, boys. Who's ready to put it to work?
Me.
There's only one way to settle this.
Where'd he come from?
I win. Never saw him coming.
Must be the camo.
Drive off in a new John Deere from SunSouth right now with 0% financing on select models. SunSouth, equipment for those that do.
At Jack Houston Memorial Hospital, our focus is you.
Even though we performed more than 1,300 joint replacements last year, we treat you like you are our only patient. Your surgeon explains your joint replacement, so nothing is a surprise. Our team knows your treatment plan, and we work together to get you back on your feet again. That's why our hospital is recognized year after year as a leader in patient satisfaction and quality of care. Jack Houston Memorial Hospital. Excellence, always.
Let's go!
Woo! Woo! Yeah! Woo-hoo-hoo-hoo! Football time!
Set the tone!
Kyle, tie your shoes, tie your shoes.
Yeah, good job!
Woo!
Yeah! Grab a Pepsi Wild Cherry and get wild.
We're always going a million different directions.
But Kinetic Credit Union makes it easy for all of us to stay connected all in one place.
With the Kinetic mobile app, we both can monitor our accounts on the go. We can create account alerts so we know when there's a change, apply for a loan or credit card. We can even open a new account.
Plus, you can quickly pay bills, transfer money, or make a deposit anytime, anywhere.
Kinetic makes our life a whole lot easier.
Kinetic Credit Union, the energy for your dreams.
My dog, Georgette, was diagnosed with cancer. After her treatment, we would pass Chick-fil-A. I started seeing Mr. Brian often. She would get her little treat of whipped cream.
We recognize each other, Georgette and I do. That particular day, Elaine pulls up. She said, Georgette is cancer-free.
I came around the corner with Georgette in my car, saw all the employees out there just, like, clapping and cheering. I started getting really emotional because I was just like, that's so nice.
We love all our customers that come through. This one just happens to have four legs. Congratulations, Georgette.
Tom Callahan here with you. We appreciate you joining us here on the YouTube side as well as on the radio side. 106.9 Rocks out of Columbus, Georgia, and at Columbus River Dragons on YouTube. And let's take a look back at our scoring summary here. Back in the first, the River Dragons actually held a 1-0 lead in this game. 5:07 in. Kyle Moore with the goal and a feed down low from Justin McDonald. Moore goes backhand to forehand, tucks it around the left pad of the goaltender Blake Weirich for a 1-0 lead. Ryan Hunter also a helper on that goal. And Columbus was off and running, but back came the Seawolves at 9:59. A power play goal for Jackson Bond as he was sprung on a breakaway on a pass from Philip Wong. They've now added an assist to Portillo on that goal to make it 1-1 at the time. And then late in the frame at 18:47, turnover behind the River Dragons net. I thought it was a bad bounce off a stanchion. Perhaps it caromed off of Lind, but now they're actually adding even another assist onto this goal to David Aslin. But so now Aslin and Lind setting up Lucas Helland. 18:47, and it's 2-1 Seawolves at the end of the period here. Shots on goal in favor of Columbus, 11-5. Power plays in the period. Mississippi finished 1-for-3 with a man advantage. River Dragons went 0-for-2. So not a great period for Columbus overall. Nice to see the streak continuing for Justin McDonald. Now 31 games with a point, 70 points in that stretch. That is an unbelievable total from McDonald. Let's have a look at the Zelmo Zippin' Out of Town scoreboard. And we're the only game in the FPHL here tonight. So let's check out the NHL on a Thursday night. Pretty busy. And it's 2-1 Bruins now over the Maple Leafs. That game is late in the second period. 2-1 Hurricanes over the Canadiens. Oilers have gotten one back, but the Blue Jackets continue to carry a 3-1 lead. That game has moved into the third period now. At the second intermission, Flyers and Panthers are tied up at 1. Also at the second period intermission, Devils now up 3-1 on the St. Louis Blues. Capitals up 5-0 on the Pittsburgh Penguins, who are in seller mode this year at the deadline as well. Calgary Flames have pulled out in front of the Tampa Bay Lightning 4-2. Is anybody else wondering which Lightning team is the real Lightning team this year? Those guys have been so hot and cold this year. Just, you know, it's going to end up, the Lightning, I'm sure they'll make the playoffs. We'll see how they do once they get in, but boy, it's going to be interesting this year. There is a potential for a first-round matchup between Tampa Bay and Florida. That would be intense. At the first intermission, the Nashville Predators lead the Buffalo Sabres 2-1. Coming up here at the top of the hour, just a couple of minutes away from Wild at the Arizona Coyotes. 10 o'clock Eastern, you've got Canucks at Golden Knights 10:30 Eastern. Senators at Kings. Islanders are at the Sharks. And in the men's college basketball out-of-town scoreboard, no one's tipped off yet. Washington at number 8, Washington State coming up here in a couple of minutes. And then at 9:30 Eastern, number 5, Arizona takes on UCLA. NHL trade deadline stuff. And today, busy again today with the trade deadline coming tomorrow. Yakov Trenin and Graham Sward go to the Colorado Avalanche from the Nashville Predators for defenseman Jeremy Hansel and a 25 third rounder. Edmonton picks up defenseman Troy Stecker and a 7th rounder in 24 from the Coyotes for a 4th rounder in 27. Left wing Brandon Duhaime goes to the Colorado Avalanche for a 3rd rounder to the Minnesota Wild. That's due in 2026. Anthony Beauvillier goes to Nashville, the left winger heading over for a 5th round pick in this year's draft. Maple Leafs get Joel Edmondson, the defender from the Washington Capitals, for a 24 3rd round and a 25 5th round. Late last night, this one came in. And defenseman Noah Hanifin went to the Vegas Golden Knights for defenseman Daniil Miromanov and a conditional 25 first rounder to the Calgary Flames and a 2025 third round pick, also conditional. By the way, Philadelphia receives a 2024 fifth round pick from Vegas in that deal as well. And yesterday, deals that went down, Alex Wenberg goes to the New York Rangers for a 2nd round and 4th rounder going to the Kraken. The Sabres pick up defenseman Bowen Byram from the Colorado Avalanche for center Casey Mittelstadt. And that was after the Avalanche picked up defenseman Sean Walker and a 26 5th rounder from the Flyers for center Ryan Johansson and a conditional 25 1st rounder. Adam Henrique and Sam Carrick, couple of forwards in a 24 7th round pick going to the Oilers for a 24 1st rounder and a 25 5th rounder conditional pick to the Anaheim Ducks. The Ducks retaining 50% of Henrique and Carrick's cap hits, and the Lightning get a conditional 2025 4th round pick to retain an additional 25% of Henrique's cap hit. Oilers also get goaltender Ty Taylor in the deal. And the other big one yesterday, Vladimir Tarasenko heading to the Florida Panthers for a conditional 2024 fourth rounder and a 2025 third rounder to the Senators. Now, can Tarasenko stay healthy? Can he fit in Florida? Can he be an impact player? I think he can. Will he? Well, that's kind of the gamble of that trade, is it not? So we'll see how that's all going to play itself out. But that is where we are right now. At the NHL trade deadline looming tomorrow at 3 p.m. So that's your Zelmo Zippin' out-of-town scoreboard. That's also it for our first period intermission report brought to you by SunSouth John Deere. 2-1 Mississippi in the lead over your Columbus River Dragons 20 minutes into it. Both teams scanning 5 aside. When we return, stay tuned. There's plenty more hockey action coming your way. This is Columbus River Dragons Hockey.
Just the two of us. We can make it if we try. Just the two of us.
Get two entrees and an appetizer for $25 only at Applebee's.
At Beam, we take pride in being a part of our community, and we're committed to seeing it grow. We continually volunteer with organizations that are making a difference. Together, we are building a better community while building the best internet that exceeds the technology of metropolitan cities. But more importantly, one that connects us all. We want to ensure reliability, so for this reason, we're willing to go the extra mile. We aim to provide the community with high-quality internet and cable services, because we live here too. Because at Beam, community is not just a place. It's the way we do business.
Winter is upon us. We must prepare. Cold and darkness will spread across the land. The nights will be long.
Hey, what are you guys doing? Air Force is here to fix the heat.
Don't let winter leave you out in the cold. Call Air Force Heating and Air now for our special $79 AC gas furnace or heat pump tune-up, only for a limited time. Air Force Heating and Air is always here for you.
At Jack Houston Memorial Hospital, our focus is you. Even though we performed more than 1,300 joint replacements last year, we treat you like you are our only patient. Your surgeon explains your joint replacement, so nothing is a surprise. Our team knows your treatment plan, and we work together to get you back on your feet again. That's why our hospital is recognized year after year as a leader in patient satisfaction and quality of care. Jack Houston Memorial Hospital. Excellence, always.
Thank you. Tim Hortons has a new $6 breakfast bundle with a mouthwatering breakfast sandwich, a golden hash brown with a small hot or iced coffee, and a classic donut made for your me time. Oh, and yours too, the $6 breakfast bundle.
Here he comes, boys.
Sure is beautiful.
Here it is, boys. Who's ready to put it to work?
Me.
There's only one way to settle this.
Where'd he come from?
I win. Never saw him coming.
Must be the camo.
Drive off in a new John Deere from SunSouth right now with 0% financing on select models. SunSouth, equipment for those that do.
Back here at the Mississippi Gulf Coast Coliseum, Tom Callahan here with you. It's the Columbus River Dragons returning to the ice for period number two. Taylor Joseph down in the net to the left of the broadcast location, just waiting for the Seawolves to hop back on the ice here. Columbus trailing 2-1 here after one period of play. Can they get it in gear and jump back in the lead? Well, they got 40 minutes to try to come back on the Seawolves hockey team. Tonight's second period is presented by WOW Internet, proud to sponsor the Columbus River Dragons this season. Team up with WOW for fast home internet for $30 per month. It's a good deal for good sports fans. Go Dragons! River Dragons hockey also brought to you by River City Swing Sets. Save big right now at River City Swing Sets, your local Gorilla Playsets authorized showroom, offering lifetime warranty swing sets and basketball goals, swings, slides, and more. Check out RiverCitySwingSets.com for the full lineup. Get your big save at River City Swing Sets with free installation on any swing set purchased by saying, "Go River Dragons." Seawolves back out there on the ice. Blake Weirich down to the right of our broadcast location. Getting ready in his crease. Seawolves in the blue home uniforms here on a Thursday evening. Only game in the FPHL. We welcome all the fans of any other FPHL teams checking it out here tonight. Thank you so much for being with us. Faceoff will come up at center here. Five on five, we start the second. Bersani, Wickline, Storjahan up front. Shinkarik and Anderson on defense.
Seawolves fans, make some noise!
And hang on a minute. The door was not shut coming out of the River Dragons locker room area. Now it's shut. Let's do it again. Okay, now we're officially underway. Seawolves will win the faceoff here. They'll look to set it up, tip it on down the ice. Joseph out to play it behind the net, leaves it into the far corner. Shinkarik reversing it around. Here's Anderson to Wickline. Wickline back towards Anderson. And he'll move it ahead. Bersani. Send it down the ice. And now the Seawolves, chance to regroup as they'll move it around onto the near side. Helland pulls it right back down. Wickline up on him on the forecheck. Wickline in the corner trying to steal it away over there. Tied up with Barr. Puck moving along to the right point. Anderson put it right back down low. Helland looks like he was hurt by it. Hit him behind the play. He's trying to stay out there. Doesn't even have a stick right now. River Dragons with it behind the net. Storjahan into the slot. Shot, they score! Columbus scores as cutting down from the left point. Shinkarik takes a pass to the side of the net. So very quickly, just 50 seconds into the second period, Columbus gets it back even at 2-2. Boy, that was a huge goal right there for momentum's sake and for getting the River Dragons to feel like, hey, they're right back in it and they've got the jump. So for Shinkarik, that is his 12th goal of the season. Storjahan with a real nice pass from behind the net there to get it to him in front. And the River Dragons, big one. Let's see if they keep the momentum. They fire the puck in. Weirich will catch and hang on. But that is a big one for Columbus there. Also, Lucas Helland is still kind of bent over at the bench. Helland was hurt on a collision on the wall, dropped his stick, stayed in the play, then decided to go get his stick when the puck was behind the net. And when he did that, the River Dragons basically had a 5-on-4 going, and that's when they scored the goal. Bersani also picking up an assist on the goal. Now pushing back the other way. Columbus has to fish it out of their own end as Underwood will wedge it on down the ice. Stoya chasing. And we have off icing here. Moore up on the forecheck. Puck ends up back out at center. And now on the left side, it's fed towards McDonald. McDonald backhanding it along and chasing after it into the left side corner is Hunter. He throws a heavy check there. One of the Seawolves players with the puck played ahead. Let's catch up here. Bond moving ahead and try to step in around Underwood. Nice job by Underwood to keep the body in front of him there. Now it's pushed ahead and now up the right side. Here comes McDonald moving in. Has help coming. Waiting. McDonald delays. Still delays at the dot. Gets it across to Moore, but the Seawolves had caught up by that. Left point. There's a shot coming in. Tipped out in front. Way out of play. Well, once again, Dominic Montanoc fooled me with that number 34. He's listed as 88 on the roster, but he's wearing 34 here for the Seawolves. Always throws you a little curveball. Draw will be to the right of Blake Wyrick in the net. And the puck up to the left point. River Dragons hold it in. Now plenty of room in with the wrist shot. Wyrick out to make the save there on Austin Doe, and the rebound's cleared out of the zone. Jemaev pressured at center. He'll dump it in, and Mississippi a chance to regroup. Russell looping to his right. Turn right back by Slahetka. River Dragons will dump it in. Lind after it. He's watched on the right side. Coughed it up to Petrantonio in the corner. Moving it along to Jemaev. Jemaev looking in front, trying to wrister. That one is kicked away by the stick there of Wyrick. Petrantonio on it. Sends it behind the net to Doe, who's pinned up. Puck free to the near corner. Mississippi will get there first off the glass. It kicks out to center. Duncan has to play it to an open wing, then gets knocked down for his trouble. Duncan's slow to get up. That's not a good sign either. Duncan's going to have to head off the ice. Petrantonio trying to backhand it in. Seawolves trying to move it ahead here. Blocked at center by Slahecka. Now it's tossed in. And after it is Shinkarik. Shinkarik up the right side. His pass hit a leg, didn't get through. Pushed across by Columbus. Here's Swan on the left side to center. Swan trouble with it, but Slahetka up. Feeds it right side, too far for Wickline. Seawolves bank it back to the line off Shinkarik. A bouncer that gets out of the zone. Barr moving it ahead. Two-on-one developing here. Pass across off the skates and right in front. Shinkarik took it away on the doorstep. Now there's a shot in the left pad saved by Joseph. Puck ends up at the left point, and it goes past the defender, Lambert, all the way down the ice. No icing. Not quite 4 minutes gone here in this second period. Game is tied up at two. River Dragons got a goal within the first minute. Shinkarik scoring to even things right back up. But the puck has been bouncing here a little bit to start the second period. Columbus trying to take advantage now. Wick line up, but Storjahan ahead of him. And he'll flip it across. Storjahan shot, and that one a little knuckler in on goal that Wyrick is able to control, and he will hang on. 4-12 into period number two. Faceoff will be to the right of Blake Wyrick in the Seawolves net. Columbus is going to counter with McDonald, Moore, and Hunter. Bockwell and Underwood. Faceoff to the right of the Seawolves net. And the faceoff is one over to the wall, played over to the near side by Moore. Bond on it there. Bond will go back across. And at center, Montanac squeezed off the puck but did get it ahead. Right side here's Wong in. Wrist shot, he scores. Wong with a wrister that beats Taylor Joseph low to the blocker's side. And the Seawolves are right back in front. It's 3-2. Philip Wong with his 13th goal of the year. 4:27 into the second period. And Mississippi not going quietly here. They push right back in front. River Dragons back after it. Into their own end. That's Duncan, who was knocked down. Puck in front. Wong, a backhand. And, oh, Joseph just got a piece, and it might have hit the post. Kept in at the left point. Around it rolls to the far side. Stoya with a shot. That off a shin pad out to center. Hunter trying to get to the loose puck. And now it's turned back into the River Dragons end of things. Over to the far side. Slaheka chomping away at it. Tied up in the pile over there. McDonald trying to help dig it out. Up the boards it goes to Hunter. Hunter picks it out of Bond Skates. Now here's Moore into the right side. In over the line, feeds it in front. It's cleared away and not out. Duncan took a hit, but the puck goes out anyway. So Montanak and Nielsen pick up the assists on the goal for the Seawolves. The hitting picks up a little bit here in this period. River Dragons push in left side. Here's McDonald looping behind the net. Out the near side, centering. It's pinched away at the post. And now falling in behind the play as Hunter looks like he's all right, but heading to the bench as the Seawolves attack, but they put themselves offside at the line. And they whistle the play down. 5:53 into the second period. That offside brought to you by Old School Barbershop, and it takes us to a break. We'll tell you more about Old School Barbershop when we come back. River Dragons trailing 3-2 to the Mississippi Seawolves. This is Columbus River Dragons Hockey.
Good internet.
Get upfront surprise-free pricing with Wi-Fi modem included and no data caps. Plus bundle internet 300 with YouTube TV for just $92.99 per month for 12 months with auto pay and paperless billing.
Wow.
Get upfront surprise-free pricing with Wi-Fi modem included and no data caps. All for only $30 a month with auto pay and paperless billing.
The energy for your dreams.
Back here at the Mississippi Gulf Coast Coliseum, Tom Callahan here with you. The offside that was brought to you by Old School Barbershop. Don't forget, you can book online anytime, Old School Barbershop. They're online, oldschoolbarbershop.com, and through their Instagram and their Facebook. Reservations highly recommended, but if your sides are a little off, get lined up at Old School Barbershop. All right, puck is down, River Dragons. 5-on-5, we skate here. 3-2 Mississippi in the lead. It's Petrantonio out with Jemayev and Doe as the captain dumps it into the right wing corner. Jemayev up after the puck. He runs into Lind in the corner. Doe trying to dig it free as well. And now it ends up on the near side. Here's a chance up top. Doe in the slot. A shot. Save made. A little bit of a hairy moment on the rebound there, but Weirich finds it. Hangs on. Faceoff will end up to the left of that Seawolves goal. 6:16 gone here in the second. 3-2 your score. Petrantonio, Doe, Jemayev out up front, and now it's Shinkirik and Anderson on the points. Draw one back by Mississippi, but Petrantonio quickly on it, steals a puck behind the net, wraps it around in front, and over to Jemayev. His shot, that hit Lind. Jemayev after it behind the net, leaving it off for Doe. This line trying to generate some excitement here in the offensive end. Into the slot, Petrantonio, wheels on the left side now, cutting. Back up the wall now, spinning with it in space, feeds it low for Jemayev. Jemayev a backhand feed, side of the net. Almost stolen away by Shinkirik. He ran into Doe. Both of them go down, and now a chance for the Seawolves to push ahead. Here comes Mississippi, but they'll flip it into the corner and chase after the dump. Petrantonio back defensively, sends it around the glass and out. But Columbus trying to get a little line change going here. They had some good motion and rotation going in the offensive zone, just couldn't capitalize on it. As it's banked towards the line, a bouncer that does find its way over. Storjahan on it there. He'll dump it in on the right side. Columbus finishing its line change while Stoya goes back after the puck. Far side, and it's Nielsen who ends up with it. Wick line out there now, joining Storjahan and Bersani. Wick line up the left side, intercepts a pass on the wing. He'll curl back up the wall, feeding up to the left point. Shot coming in, blocked by traffic in front, bouncing in the slot. Columbus couldn't get to the rebound. And now at center, it's turned right back in by Underwood. Wyrick's going to have to come out and play it to the near corner. Montanac on it. He'll bank it around to the far side. Ends up with Nielsen. Nielsen out to center off a skate, and it ends up with Underwood. River Dragons on a quick regroup here. Cross-ice pass to Underwood. Looking for Wickline. Buckwell on the far side corner after it. Storjahan with it. And now Columbus again on the attack. Wickline on the left side. He is rubbed off on the wall, spun down to the ice. Now back of the wing. Here's Bond with some speed, carrying wide in with a shot. Missed on the stick side. On the right point, there's a shot in. That one hit the outside of the net. Ends up in the far side corner. Seawolves trying to buzz a little on the offensive side, but Portillo's knocked off the puck. Bockwell around to the point, not out. Bouncer there. Storjahan can't clear. There's a long shot in, blocked away by Joseph. And now turning it ahead is Moore. Kyle Moore steps around one. Moore in. He's got an angle. Stops, trying to toe drag, but Russell knocked it away. Right point, Underwood holding it in. He fed it wide on the left side. Here's Slahetka down for the point. Slahetka lost it. Russell tied up by Slahetka. Puck on the wall. They try to kick it into the slot. Ends up in the corner. Centering attempt for McDonald. Tipped away from him, and out it goes. River Dragons right back in. Here's Moore on the right side. Into the corner. He's in there against Russell. Kyle Moore. Side of the net, McDonald carries behind, out the far side on the backhand. McDonald stops to the left half wall, in space, feeds it up top, and it bounces over the stick of Duncan. He had his chase to center, he'll put it back in. Well, the River Dragons trying to be really pesky right now in this forecheck. They force a long pass, turned over to Slahetka at center. Petrantonio tips it on, 2-on-1, here's Hunter, left side with McDonald. Hunter lost the puck! Hunter just lost the puck in space. And the scoring chance by the boards. Long stretch, cut off. Good read by Slahetka. Back the other way. Here's Petrantonio walking it in, feeding it across. Pass didn't connect. Off-angle chance off the outside of the net by Jemayev. Now Doe on the far side. Couldn't get it to go, and now the Seawolves push the other way. Mississippi up the left-wing side, cutting it over the line. There's a shot by Lissio. That one is blocked. Barr shoves it around. Onto the far side. Here's Doe. Little wedge into space out at center. Jemayev will pick it up there. Jemayev in on the right wing. Feeds it across. Petrantonio trying to catch up. Helland will get there first. Sends it back on the far wing. Kuznetsov. He'll just swing it out to center. Columbus tipping it back. A little miscommunication there. Jemayev will get it ahead for Shinkarik, though. And now here's Lind. Curling left side. Aslan. Off the linesman to center. Petrantonio back with it quickly ahead. And now Doe trying to cut through the D, but had that one knocked away. 9:27 to go here in the second. 3-2 Mississippi in the lead as the puck sent down. That'll be an icing call. And that'll get us a break here. 9:23 left to go in this second period. 3-2 Mississippi in the lead. Second period action brought to you by WOW Internet on Columbus River Dragons Hockey.
Good internet. With WOW, you now get upfront surprise-free pricing with Wi-Fi modem included and no data caps, all for only $30 a month with autopay and paperless billing.
Wow.
Just the two of us. We can make it if we try. Just the two of us.
Get two entrees and an appetizer for $25 only at Applebee's.
Good internet.
Get upfront surprise-free pricing with Wi-Fi modem included and no data caps. Plus bundle internet 300 with YouTube TV for just $92.99 per month for 12 months with autopay and paperless billing.
Wow.
What? Tim Hortons has a new $6 breakfast bundle? With a mouthwatering breakfast sandwich, a golden hash brown with a small hot or iced coffee, and a classic donut made for your me time. Oh, and yours too. The $6 breakfast bundle at your neighborhood Tim's.
All right, we are back here as the Kiss Cam rolls out here in Mississippi. Seawolves, River Dragons. Second game in a row between these two teams. Last night, Columbus won 3-1. Tonight, Columbus trails 3-2. About halfway through it here. 9:23 to go in the second. Faceoff will be down to the left of Blake Weirich in the Seawolves net. Columbus came out, tied it within the first minute of the second period on a Carter Shinkarik goal. But then Philip Wong, he scored not that long after, and the Seawolves have been in the lead once again here, and Columbus starting to wake up a little. I will say, I felt better about the River Dragons' performance here in the second period. They are starting to push more, get some more offensive zone time. But they're really going to need to make sure that they've got it in gear here if they want to come out with the 3 points. They still have some work ahead of them. Seawolves win the draw on their own end, try to clear. Wickline is hooked up, lost a mitt in the process. Puck did get out. Storjahan trying to get to the discarded mitt. But play was offside in the process. Mississippi on the regroup, looking to push it ahead through center. On the right side, here's Lind all the way up for the D spot, wraps it around behind the net. Lind by himself, though, as his mates were changing. Now he gets the puck ahead. Here's Wickline moving it up, looking for Shinkarik, trying to push in on the right side. Now up top it goes off the skate of Shinkarik and out of the zone. River Dragons likewise to the line change here as it's poked deep by Wickline. McDonald will step out with Moore and Hunter. And a lead pass intercepted by McDonald in the high slot area, cutting to his left. McDonald to the far dot. His shot missed the net. Around it goes to the right point. Underwood had to give up the point. Put the puck back in, but it was offside. Nielsen at center. Turn that one over. Now Shinkarik back the other way, cutting it over the line, leaving it onto the right side. McDonald chasing it off the half wall, feeds it in front. Off the skate of Hunter in on goal, and the save made by Weirich. He's able to hang on to that one. Down low, looking for it through the traffic. 8:07 to go in the second. 3-2. Mississippi in the lead. McDonald, Moore, Hunter up front. Underwood and Bockwell on the points. Puck is tied up, ends up on the near wall. Played away from Hunter and out to center. Underwood trying to push it back the other way as the Seawolves dump it in from center ice. Left there by Joseph for Underwood. Right side to Moore. Moore looking to move it ahead and now 2-on-1 developing. McDonald in looking cross ice. Hunter could only tip it wide of the net. Back the other way. The Seawolves do get it to the line and now out. Here's Lisio on the left side trying to walk that one in. Underwood back into the corner, tied up. Now Bersani out there. He'll lift that puck out to center. Well, the River Dragons just missing a couple connections here. Unable to pull some things off, but they've been pushing. McDonald still on the left side, trying to be disruptive. Gets it into the slot to Hunter. A backhand try, and the save made by Weirich coming to his left. He'll gobble that up and hang on. Seven 12 to go here in the second. 3-2 Seawolves. Petrantonio will take this faceoff across from Barr. Out with Chimaev and Doe. Slaheka and Duncan on defense. Actually, that is Swan on the left side. Doe is not out there for this shift. So it's one back to the point. Slaheka on it. Wrist shot through traffic. That one just missed the net. Swan after the rebound. This is pushed around to the near side. Chimaev down low for Swan. Swan tried to throw it in front, hit the back of the net, came back to him. Swan will try the backhand out the far side. Still pushing his way along. Sequoia Swan cycles it towards Chimaev. Penalty coming up against the Seawolves. Duncan down low with a chance to walk in front. A backhand save made. Weirich will hold the puck. And the River Dragons go into the power play. Holding the call. And Columbus to its third power play chance of the game. Brought to you by The Loft. The Loft features live music every Friday and Saturday night. Show your River Dragons ticket stub for 2-for-1 cover only at the Loft in downtown Columbus. And we'll keep you posted on when the next post-game party with the River Dragons is coming up. And that one, not too far away on the calendar. We got a couple more of those scheduled. Time of the penalty, 13-14. Russell is the guilty party into the box. Faceoff pushed over to the near side. And it is clear to line, but not out. Held in by the River Dragons. Petrantonio on the left side. Into the left wing corner. Moore trying to work it free. Petrantonio in that pile. And now fed up top. Here's McDonald. McDonald over to Doe. One-time shot. Weirich save. And he holds a rebound coming to his left. He'll hold on for another draw here. 25 seconds gone to the man advantage. 6:20 left to go in the second period. 3-2 Mississippi. Face off, tied up on the dot. Ends up in the near side. Here's Petrantonio over Storjahan. Fed around to the far side. Moore chasing. Down for the left point. It is Doe. Storjahan banks it up top. Columbus controlling, trying to slow it down. Here's Moore, top of the slot. Walks around one. He's got a seam, a wrist shot. And again, Weirich the save. But Columbus has been putting him right into the middle of the goaltender. That Seawolf on the logo is going to have a black eye by the time this game's over. 5:59 to go in the second, 3-2 your score, 1:13 to go on the power play for Columbus. They'll switch up the unit. Jemayev in for this faceoff here, wins it back, and toward the point it goes. Chance to clear, and Seawolves do get it out just over the head of Shinkarik. Slahedka back after it. Plays it to an open wing, and really nobody there. Shinkarik has to loop back for it in his own end. Shinkarik on the left side, getting it ahead. Jemayev steps in over the line. Stops in the left wing. Jemayev feeds it down low. Wickline curling on the left side with it. He'll leave it off. Slahedka feeds in front. Wickline's tip goes behind the net. Down to the left point. Shinkarik steps down with it to the left half boards. Shinkarik, side of the net. Wickline tried to feed it right in front there. Didn't get it through. Shinkarik on it again. Gets it up top. Slahedka down low. Chance towards Jemayev. Couldn't get it to him. Again, puck left to go to the point. Shinkarik to the left side. Slahedka into the slot again for Jemayev. He's tied up. Still can't get a shot away. Puck to the corner. Wickline on it. Power play time ticking down. 12 seconds. Shinkarik up top. Wrister through traffic. Missed the net. Lynn near side. Bouncer couldn't get to it. And a chance to clear, sent down by the Seawolves. That'll do it. Out of the box, Russell. And the Seawolves penalty kill 3-for-3 now. Wickline missing the tip. That'll be an icing the other way. No, it will not. Good hustle by Bersani to break that one up. Lynn trying to move it the other way. Kicks it on to Wong. Wong at the line, ran into his own man, turned it over. Bersani pushed it away to center. Seawolves, however, get it right back. Bond trying to push into the left wing corner, battling there. Underwood took it away from him. Bersani tried to jam it out, hit Stoya. Bersani on it again. This time he'll flip it off the glass ahead, looking for Storjahan. And that one just directed away from Swan. Stoya turning it back into the right side. Trying to work well out of Bersani. Stoya lost it in the corner, though. Underwood will stop. Slow it down a little here. Try the right side, Bockwell. Bockwell ahead. Bank pass went behind Swan. 3:49 to go in the second. 3-2 your score. Seawolves in the lead. Mississippi up the right side. Out to center. Here's Wong. Wong ran into traffic but continues on. Right side in with a wrist shot and a blocker saved there by Joseph. On to the near side. That one is sent deep by Mississippi Nielsen. Back after it on the left side. He's knocked down by Swan. Puck underneath him. Now he gets up. Puck is pushed to the right point. Russell, turnaround chance right into the chest protector of Taylor Joseph. He'll hang on to get a whistle with 3:22 to go in the second. 3-2 your score. Back with more of the WOW Internet second period in just a moment on River Dragons Hockey.
Good internet.
With WOW, you now get upfront surprise-free pricing with Wi-Fi modem included and no data caps. All for only $30 a month with auto pay and paperless billing.
Wow.
Here he comes, boys.
Sure is beautiful.
Here it is, boys. Who's ready to put it to work?
Me? There's only one way to settle this.
Rock.
Where'd he come from?
I win. Never saw him coming.
Must be the camo.
Drive off in a new John Deere from SunSouth right now with 0% financing on select models. SunSouth, equipment for those that do.
Get upfront surprise-free pricing with Wi-Fi modem included and no data caps. Plus, bundle internet 300 with YouTube TV for just $92.99 per month for 12 months with autopay and paperless billing.
Wow.
All right, we are back here in the second period with 3:22 to go. 3-2 your score. Mississippi in the lead. Tom Callahan here with you. Drew Pierce producing. Want to say hello to everyone on the YouTube side at Columbus River Dragons and on the radio side, 106.9 Rocks in Columbus. Taylor Joseph out for a little stroll before coming back into the crease to his left for the faceoff here. McDonald in there, across from Helen. River Dragons jumped early there. Moore went for a little bit of a swim and that'll force him to redo the faceoff. See if they leave McDonald in or not. Nope, Ryan Hunter's going to have to come in for the faceoff. Hunter in across from Helland. Hunter swipes early and McDonald jumped. This time the puck finally down, pushed in behind the Columbus net. Anderson over after it, tries the left side, gets it ahead towards Hunter. River Dragons ahead here, Shinkarik jumping into the play. He'll wedge that one into the right side corner. It dies off the glass, fed onto the far side. Kuznetsov tries to go right back behind the net. Now the near wing attempt to clear. Shinkarik steps down for the right point to keep the puck deep. Ryan Hunter after it, trying to battle his way free on the right side. Up the half wall to the right point. Shinkarik. Shinkarik's shot. That one deflected and blocked off a shin pad in front. And now the Seawolves get it out over the line. Shinkarik turning it right back in. Here's Kyle Moore cutting in. Moore right side in with a wrist shot. Save Weirich. And the rebound swatted away the line. Not out. Shinkarik a shot. Deflects off a defender and wide. On the far side, here's Hunter. They're going to tie it up, looking for a little help from Moore in the pile. Kyle Moore ends up with it. Moore on the wing, in space, lost it, pushed out to center. Anderson has to go back for it, ties it up there at center. Good battle by Hugh Anderson as he sends it back in. McDonald after the puck. McDonald on the far side, into the slot, and that pass just missed. Turned back out by Lisio and chased down by Slahetka. Slahetka on the roller, back into the River Dragons end. He'll get it back now behind the net from Shinkarik. Pressured down there by Lisio. Shinkarik has to sweep it away. Pass just missed. Doe kept into the line with a long shot blocked by Slahetka. Slahetka, right wing feed. Petrantonio picks it up as Jemayev going to the net. Looking to slide it through. Jemayev couldn't get his stick on it. Left side here's Doe. Doe down low to Jemayev. Jemayev chases it to the near side. Jemayev behind the net. Doe. Doe in the backhand. Chopped away to the corner. Now he gets it back, cycles around. Petrantonio on the left side. Petrantonio watched by Aslan over there. A minute and a half to go here in the second. 3-2 Seawolves. Left point kept in by Duncan. Fed in behind the net. Petrantonio on the rolling puck, trying to kick it free as he's tied up by Aslan. Aslan up with it off the glass. Bouncer not out. Kept in by Columbus, but only momentarily. Now sent down. This will be an icing call. If it has the gas, it doesn't. Dies just in front of the line. Both teams changing as the River Dragons send it the other way. Wickline just getting a tip to it. That way the River Dragons don't get nailed for an icing. Here's Bersani on it. Left point. Gets it to Duncan. Duncan with a long shot in. That one blocked off Wickline. Wickline on it. Left side gets it to Bersani. Bersani to the left point. And that one bounces past Duncan all the way down the ice. Joseph's going to have to come way out to play it. He'll get it across to Slahetka. Slahetka looking ahead. Puck at the line. River Dragons. Wickline trouble with it. Couldn't get it into the zone. Now back, a chance on the right side. Bond him, long slapper, shoulder save. Joseph trying to shake that one off, might have stung him. Round to the near side, it comes Stoya keeping at the point, and out it goes. Oh, they said onside, boy, that puck came out. Puck into the slot, another chance, blocked in front. And now pushed in here. Storjahan and now 3-on-2 developing. Bersani up. Storjahan right side. And wrist shot. He missed the net. That one might have been tipped wide off the shaft of Russell's stick. Turned over at center. Pushing back in is Underwood. Underwood with his shot deflects into the slot. Backhanded away. 7 seconds to go in the period. Columbus will chase it down. And we're going to head to the rooms with a 3-2 Seawolves lead up on the board. Boy, it got wide open there at the end of the period. The River Dragons unable to find another goal for the equalizer. Columbus did tie it up early in the second, but again, Mississippi jumped back out in front. Seawolves led after one. They now lead after two. And the River Dragons are going to have some figuring to do here. They need at least two. Although, I will say, better second half of the second period than really what we've seen for the River Dragons here in the first four and a half periods so far. This two-game set here in Mississippi. So they will head off the ice. 3-2, Mississippi in the lead. We will head into our second period intermission report, which is brought to you by Shredaway. And we'll fire up the old mailbag in the second segment. If you want to text your question to 844-987-4456, 844-987-4456. And please include your name and a chance to win an Ignite Sports prize pack in there as well to the best question. And that is solely judged by me. It's my opinion, and it's an opinion, so it can't be wrong. Even though Drew tells me it might be wrong, it's not wrong. 3-2, Seawolves in the lead, 40 minutes in. We'll take a break. Let's come back with more in a moment. Scoring Rams, almost hipping out of town. Scoreboard more coming your way on Columbus River Dragons Hockey.
Just the two of us. We can make it if we try. Just the two of us.
Get two entrees and an appetizer for $25 only at Applebee's.
At Beam, we take pride in being a part of our community, and we're committed to seeing it grow. We continually volunteer with organizations that are making a difference. Together, we are building a better community while building the best internet that exceeds the technology of metropolitan cities. But more importantly, one that connects us all. We want to ensure reliability. So for this reason, we're willing to go the extra mile. We aim to provide the community with high-quality internet and cable services because we live here too. Because at Beam, community is not just a place. It's the way we do business.
Winter is upon us. We must prepare. Cold and darkness will spread across the land. The nights will be long.
Hey, what are you guys doing? Air Force is here to fix the heat.
Don't let winter leave you out in the cold. Call Air Force Heating and Air now for our special $79 AC gas furnace or heat pump tune-up, only for a limited time. Air Force Heating and Air is always here for you.
At Jack Houston Memorial Hospital, our focus is you. Even though we performed more than 1,300 joint replacements last year, we treat you like you are our only patient. Your surgeon explains your joint replacement, so nothing is a surprise. Our team knows your treatment plan, and we work together to get you back on your feet again. That's why our hospital is recognized year after year as a leader in patient satisfaction and quality of care. Jack Houston Memorial Hospital. Excellence, always.
Tim Hortons has a new $6 breakfast bundle with a mouthwatering breakfast sandwich, a golden hash brown with a small hot or iced coffee, and a classic donut made for your me time. Oh, and yours too, the $6 breakfast bundle.
Shh, shh, shh. Brum, dum, dum. Get low, get low, get low. 369, ooh, she fine. Hoping she can sing it to me one more time. Get low, get low, get low, get low.
Grab a Pepsi Wild Cherry and get wild.
I'm going to go ahead and just warn everybody right now. We're having a couple issues with Vozzy, and I'm getting Getting some issues with the text to win, so we may or may not end up doing the mailbag tonight. And I love that all of you participate so well in this, and I feel bad right now, but I'm hoping this clears itself up by the time we get to it next segment. So fingers crossed. I'm not telling you not to send your questions in, but I am telling you that I may not get them today. So just a little heads up. But anyway, 844-987-4456. 844-987-4456. Best question has a chance to win a River Dragons and Ignite Sports prize pack. So hopefully that works itself out. But in the meantime, we have a lot to get to here because we have an entire scoring ramp. We have an out-of-town scoreboard, and we have trade updates in the NHL to get to as well. The trade deadline is tomorrow. Our trade deadline's coming up as well in the FPHL in the not-too-distant future. And I'm not sure if one of your questions is, will the River Dragons be active? I'm not entirely sure. I don't think you often see trades at the FPHL level that really are hockey trades. And I think Columbus, if they were going to make a trade right now, would have to make a hockey trade because the team is, you know, loaded with a lot of talent. Well, you're not going to give something up when you're a first-place team and not get anything back. And I just don't know how many teams would make that kind of trade right now. Especially, here's the other thing. Teams are looking at Columbus and saying, why do we want to make those guys better? First team to 100 points in the league, best team in the league right now. No one is in a hurry to make a deal with the Columbus River Dragons. That's the other thing you have to keep in mind. You might be one of the people out there saying, hey, why don't we go out and get a player and make us even better than we are, which would be fantastic. I think everyone would jump at that chance. However, you got to give something up to get something. Keep that in mind. So that might be your favorite player. But the other thing is no one's in a hurry to make Columbus any better than they already are. 3-2 is your score. Mississippi in the lead after two periods of play. Tom Callahan here with you. As we are now going to take a look at the scoring summary from that second period of action. Just 50 seconds into the second period, Carter Shinkara got the River Dragons back level at 2-2 with assists from Store Jahan and Hunter Bersani. And so at that point, the River Dragons, great start to the period, came out with some jump, capitalized within the first minute of the period. But from there, it was a little bit uneven again. I think the second period was better than the first for the River Dragons. But at 4:27, they give up a go-ahead goal. It's Wong who scores from Nilsson and Montanac. And that goal at 4:27 made it 3-2. And then the River Dragons, despite the fact they'd swing the momentum pendulum back the other way, get some pretty good chances, just couldn't find a way to capitalize. And the River Dragons right now probably in the room saying, you know what, we're down by one, 20 minutes to go. Now, look, Columbus can score in bunches, but it needs to be a really focused, very concerted effort for this River Dragons team to come out and just really enforce their will on this Mississippi Seawolves team. We've seen them do it several times over the course of, you know, the rivalry here the last two seasons, and Columbus is a force to be reckoned with, but tonight, even last night, things just seemed a little off for this River Dragons team. So hopefully they can find that gear that they seem to be missing right now. Shots in the second period favored Columbus 12-8. And the power plays are now even at 3 apiece. The Seawolves are 1-for-3. Didn't have any chances in that period. River Dragons are 0-for-3. They had one power play chance in the period. And that is the summary for the River Dragons' second period of play. Hopefully, like I say, they're down by a goal. They might have a little something in the tank here as they consider what next and how they need to come out. And really, it's puck possession style of play and pushing back the Seawolves team. I don't think that they can do much more to cut down on the Seawolves' chances. Quite frankly, Mississippi didn't have a lot. They did capitalize on their chance. But for the River Dragons, now it is capitalizing on their chances. A couple of times in that period, there was a 2-on-1. Ryan Hunter overskated the puck, just lost it off the end of his stick. Then a few other times, passes either a little too far or tips that weren't on goal, things like that, just things that happen. And the River Dragons still trying to figure out a way to convert and get this game tied up again and behind right now by one goal. And they got another period to get it going. Hopefully they'll be able to do just that. All right, we're going to take a break. When we come back, it'll be time for the out-of-town scoreboard brought to you by Zelbo Zippin. And I'm going to see if I can get Vazi working here so we can go ahead and do the text to win here tonight. And we'll do the Tom's mailbag. So Be patient, as I always warn you. But hopefully this will be working by the time we come back. If not, it's okay. There are plenty more chances to do the mailbag for the rest of the season. So don't panic. Don't panic. 3-2, Mississippi in the lead. Back with more in a moment. This is River Dragons Hockey.
We all dream, but dreams quickly become distant memories unless we do something about it. Do everything in our power to learn to lead. At Troy University, we teach everyone to be leaders in their field. We're dedicated to teaching a new generation to lead change.
I Spice?
Wait, who's that?
It's my ex, Lemon Lime Soda.
You're looking well.
I just needed something more refreshing, more crisp. I'm a starry now.
This is intense.
He's so vulnerable.
But I love you. Please.
Ah, buddy, it'll be okay.
Or not.
Huh, Starry does taste better.
My dog, Georgette, was diagnosed with cancer. After her treatment, we would pass Chick-fil-A. I started seeing Mr. Brian often. She would get her little treat of whipped cream.
We recognize each other. Georgette and I do. That particular day, Elaine pulls up. She said, Georgette is cancer-free.
I came around the corner with Georgette in my car, saw all the employees out there just like clapping and cheering. I started getting really emotional because I was just like, that's so nice.
We love all our customers that come through. This one just happens to have four legs. Congratulations, Georgette.
Don't miss your chance to win at Victory Land Casino. We're open 24/7, so come on in for nonstop gaming action. You'll find the latest, hottest, most exciting games around, and you'll love the fun bonuses and big jackpots. Plus, you can watch and wager on horse and greyhound races from all over the world. Your best bet for big wins is just minutes away at Victory Land Casino, where you can be a winner too. Victory Land Casino, located off I-85 exit 22 in Shorter, Alabama. Must be 21 or older.
Mississippi Gulf Coast Coliseum, 3-2 is your score. Seawolves in the lead over your Columbus River Dragons. Tom Callahan here with you. And we appreciate you being here, whether you're on the radio side, 106.9 Rocks out of Columbus. By the way, did you know you can carry 106.9 Rocks with you wherever you go and listen online? And, you know, if you're, say you're driving, you don't want to put the YouTube feed on your phone and you want to listen to the game and you're out of radio range, you can always listen live. And, you know, carry us with you that way on the player as well. So look for 106.9 Rocks out of Columbus, and you can always get the audio of the play-by-play always along with you here. And on the YouTube side, we're at Columbus River Dragons. River Dragons back home tomorrow night against the Carolina Thunderbirds at 7:35 p.m. on a sensory adaptive night, sponsored in conjunction with Easter Seals and a same show as we normally do, just scaled back a little bit on the lights and sound for those who have sensory issues and special needs. We will have a quiet room as well for fans who may need to take advantage of that. All you need to do is go to the customer service table outside of Section 201, and you will be escorted into that room as well. So we really appreciate the folks who help us put this game on and really make hockey for everyone. And we look forward to that game tomorrow night, River Dragons against the Thunderbirds. Right now, River Dragons trail 3-2 to Mississippi with one period left to go. Let's take a look at the Selmo Zipping Out of Town scoreboard for you. And late in the third period, the Boston Bruins with a 4-1 lead on the Toronto Maple Leafs. Hurricanes, this one's gone final now. Hurricanes 4-1 over the Montreal Canadiens. Also a couple other finals tonight. The Blue Jackets hold on to beat the Oilers 4-2. 2-1, Philadelphia defeats the Panthers this evening. Devils 4-1 over the St. Louis Blues. Capitals shut out the Penguins 6-0. Flames double up the Lightning 6-3. Game's going on right now. Preds up 2-1 on the Sabres after two periods of play. After one period, Wild and Coyotes are scoreless. Coming up here at the top of the hour, you got the Canucks at the Golden Knights. 10:30, Senators at Kings, Islanders at Sharks. And men's college basketball. At the half, number 18 Washington State trails Washington 32-30, and just underway, number 5 Arizona 7-6 over UCLA. NHL trade deadline, we did have another trade sneak in there while we were away. And this one that comes in over the wire, left wing Anthony Duclair is on his way to the Tampa Bay Lightning along with a 25 seventh rounder from the San Jose Sharks for defenseman Jack Thompson and a 24 third rounder. So that is the Lightning saying, yeah, we probably need a little bit more scoring. So the Duke goes back to Florida. He was with the Panthers not too long ago, and now he is with Tampa Bay as they try to figure out a way to get back on a good run and try to make a deep run to the Stanley Cup playoffs. They may end up facing the Panthers in the first round. Other trades today, the Predators send left wing Yakov Trenin and defenseman Graham Sward to the Colorado Avalanche for defenseman Jeremy Hansel and a 25 third rounder. Troy Stecker, the defenseman, goes to the Oilers along with a 24 seventh rounder from the Coyotes for a 27 fourth rounder. Brandon Duhaime, the left winger, to Colorado for a 26 third rounder to the Minnesota Wild. Right wing Jacob Perreault goes to the Montreal Canadiens for center Jan Mizak to the Anaheim Ducks. Left wing Anthony Beauvillier coming over to the Preds for a 24 fifth round pick. Defenseman Joel Edmondson goes to the Maple Leafs for a 24 third rounder and a 25 fifth rounder to the Capitals. And one that got in under the wire last night, defenseman Noah Hanifin to the Vegas Golden Knights from the Calgary Flames for defenseman Daniil Mirimanov, along with a 25 conditional first rounder and a conditional 25 third rounder. Philly also receives a 2024 fifth round pick from Vegas in the deal. Not going to be able to do the mailbag tonight, my apologies, but I'll try to save the questions and get those for tomorrow night's mailbag. Hopefully we'll be able to do it when we get back home. In the meantime, 3-2 is your score. Mississippi leading as we head into the third period. That's it for the Shredaway second period intermission report. Back with more in a moment on River Dragons Hockey.
Good internet. Get upfront surprise-free pricing with Wi-Fi modem included and no data caps. Plus bundle internet 300 with YouTube TV for just $92.99 per month for 12 months with autopay and paperless billing.
Wow.
What? Tim Hortons has a new $6 breakfast bundle? With a mouthwatering breakfast sandwich, a golden hash brown with a small hot or iced coffee, and a classic donut made for your me time. Oh, and yours too, the $6 breakfast bundle.
Getting low, but you're in luck. Pull your car or truck into Zelmo's, Zelmo's, Zelmo's.
This month at Zelmo's, all Celsius energy drinks, 2 for $4.
But you're in luck. Pull your car or truck into Zelmo's, Zelmo's, Zelmo's.
Always clean, always fast, always friendly. Zelmo's Zip-In, fueling life's passions for 20 years.
Winter is upon us. We must prepare. Cold and darkness will spread across the land. The nights will be long.
Hey, what are you guys doing? Air Force is here to fix the heat.
Don't let winter leave you out in the cold. Call Air Force Heating and Air now for our special $79 AC gas furnace or heat pump tune-up, only for a limited time. Air Force Heating and Air is always here for you.
Here he comes, boys.
Sure is beautiful.
Here it is, boys. Who's ready to put it to work?
Me.
There's only one way to settle this.
Where'd he come from?
I win. Never saw him coming.
Must be the camo.
Drive off in a new John Deere from SunSouth right now with 0% financing on select models. SunSouth, equipment for those that do.
as the River Dragons and the Seawolves have both returned to the ice. Third period action brought to you by Kinetic Credit Union. While we were away at break, I was just exercising my pipes there by belting out Final Countdown here in the arena by Europe. One of the better unsung 80s hair metal bands, or I'll just say metal bands of the 80s, because really, I mean, hair metal, it's not always the best term. It's not always viewed the most positively in the music community, but you know what? In the 80s, metal was metal. There were several different kinds, just like there are now. All right, underway. River Dragons going right to left in front of the broadcast location, out to center. Columbus possessing the puck. Storjahan with a pass fanned on. Russell will play it away before Bersani got there. And now the Seawolves will come back the other way, pushing in on the left wing of the long shot, deflected wide of Taylor Joseph in the River Dragons net. There's another attempt that floats over the glass. 27 seconds into period number three, we get our first whistle of the frame. Columbus down 3-2 here and looking to try to find a way to knot things up. At the very least, a regulation win would certainly be the aim for the River Dragons here, but they have to find a way to get a couple in a period. They got one in the first, one in the second. McDonald out there with Hunter and Moore. Puck tied up on the dot. McDonald moves it off the glass away to center. And pushing up on the left side here, Shinkarik up on the forecheck. Now stolen away by Hunter. Moving in. Hunter in with a shot right into the gear of Blake Weirich. Boy, they've been burying it absolutely into the guts of the goaltender all night. River Dragon shot selection is, well, they're putting it on net. I mean, you know, good things happen when you put the puck on net, but Weirich has been very square to the puck tonight and just absorbing everything. Faceoff will be to his right. McDonald in for the faceoff. And he'll win it back to the left point. Underwood on it. He'll swing it around the rim. Behind the net it goes. Stoya tied up by McDonald. Pushes it back up that near side once again. Underwood steps down for the left point to keep it alive. McDonald in the pile. Fed it past Moore. Wong behind the net after it. He'll play out the far side. And now tipped on. Wong through center with Nielsen. Feeds him right side. Nielsen with a Brister back in front. Wong, a shot tipped on goal. Fought off by Joseph. Sent the other way and now a race. Here's McDonald trying to get there ahead of Lind. He will not. And they call it an icing. Columbus will not have the benefit of a change, and now a minute and 13 seconds into this period, McDonald, Moore, and Hunter stuck out there. McDonald just takes his time, cruising back in for the faceoff. Quick word to Joseph as he skates by. He tries to push the puck ahead off the faceoff. Tied up on the left side. Wong over skates it and ends up back in the corner. McDonald after it. And he'll fire a stretch to center looking for Hunter, trying to cut him behind the D. Couldn't get it through to him. Sent back in by Aslin around the rim. McDonald lets it go to the far side. Bond is over there. McDonald puts the body on him. Nielsen tied up in behind the net by Underwood. And now turned over the slot. There's a shot. Anderson, that's blocked by Kyle Moore. Aslin down for the left corner. His chance in front blocked again by Moore out of play. And Columbus can finally get the line change that they need so badly. 1:45 into the third period. Well, we've got a moment. Let's take a break. 10 seconds along the network. Keep it legal. Station identification.
You're listening to River Dragons Hockey on WKCN HD2 Fort Moore, Columbus. And W295 AY Crystal Valley. 106.9 really rocks.
Faceoff will be to the right of the River Dragons net here. Slahetka back into the corner after it. That one fed onto the near side as Doe looking to tip it ahead. Jemayev hooked his man down to the ice there. Sent back the other way now. Columbus trying to clear up that left side. Doe tied up on the boards. They form a pile over there, the hash marks. Ends up at the right point, kept in. Shot by Montanac, save in front by Joseph. Rebound sitting in the slot. And taken away by Columbus. Puck moved ahead. Bouncer chopped at there, but chipped away ultimately. And back the other way to Lissio. Lissio up the left side. In with a shot from the wing. And that's absorbed by Joseph. He'll hang on. Face off to his right. 2:24 into the third period. Columbus is going to put Storjahan out there, along with Petrantonio and Bersani here. And I think Petro may be out just for face-off purposes, perhaps. He is taking this draw. And he does win it back. Šinkaric on it. Trying to play it around to the near side, but he lost it on the wall over there. Here's Barr, right half wall to the right point, Russell. Russell looking for a seam, threads it towards the net, kicks free to Barr, puck in on goal, Joseph will cover. He'll hang on for a draw to his left. And right now it's the Seawolves just kind of tossing pucks in on the net, trying to make some things happen. Face off now to the left of the River Dragons net. Bounce back towards the point. Russell will feed it deep. Joseph out to play it. Steers it back up the near side boards. Deflected on out to center. And it ends up with Russell back in the Seawolves' end of things as Mississippi regrouping here. And a lead pass that hit Bersani, but Bersani lost it to Barr. Barr moving it back in left side. Lead too far. Helland will chase it around behind the net. Anderson. Moving up the far side, Petrantonio back for the puck. Maybe the River Dragons have shuffled the lines a little bit here. Petrantonio, Bersani, and Storjahan out there now. Turn back, here's Russell intercepting a pass at center. Bond will pound it in as both teams start to work a change here. Šinkaric to center to Bersani. Bersani will curl back inside his own line. Moved ahead, here's Ryan Hunter. Hunter up the right side. Curls, looking for help, feeds into the slot. Late arriving, McDonald driving on the wing. Left side, feeds it in front, a left pad save. Rebound is cleared out and down the ice, chased by Underwood. Underwood will reset up the left side. Hunter tried to tip it on into the zone. Underwood following the play, did get it in. Right to the Mississippi defense, though. They get it out to center. Bond knocks that one into the River Dragons' end. Paddled away by Joseph, but now turned over side of the net. Joseph trying to help himself out. Put it right to Nielsen. Nielsen up with it left side, all the way up to the left point. Left in space there. Pass in front is cut off. Columbus will move the other way quickly. Here's McDonald in over the line. His long wrister fought off. Blocker saved there by Weirich. McDonald knocked down by Stoya on the near side. Nielsen back the other way. Nielsen had it poked off his stick there as Bockwell stepped up on him. Bockwell ends up with the puck. He'll move it ahead. Columbus pushing in on the left side. McDonald in space trying to move it into the slot. Puck drifting free, still at the near dot. Montanac on it, clearing it along. McDonald keeping it in at the left point. And now it's moved out by Mississippi. Right side, here's Portillo pushing up himself with a wrist shot. Missed the net. Around the rim it goes, and all the way to center. Two on two now. Columbus can break the other way. Now three on three. River Dragons trying to push it in front. Moore just at the end of a shift out of gas. Couldn't do much. Mississippi back the other way. That was a long shift once again for that line. Two long shifts to start the second period for the McDonald unit. Puck turned over. Duncan will get it back to Slahetka. Slahetka near side to Doe. Doe spins off the wall. Has to chase it down. No icing here. Doe gets there just ahead of it. Jemayev in the corner. Russell in the pile as well. Jemayev will swing it around the rim. Can Slahecka get there? Yes, he does. Able to keep it in the backhand. Good hustle by Nolan Slahecka. Puck drifts into the slot area. Wickline trying to get to it. Here's Doe. Slot. Jemayev shot. Save made. Rebound. In on goal. And the save by Weirich. Jemayev picked it out of the air. Bounced it off the ice, and Weirich tracked it and held it. That's going to get us to our first break of the period. 5:44 into the third, 3-2. River Dragons trailing the Seawolves. This third period brought to you by Kinetic Credit Union. We're back with more in a moment on River Dragons Hockey.
We're always going a million different directions.
But Kinetic Credit Union makes it easy for all of us to stay connected, all in one place.
With the Kinetic mobile app, we both can monitor our accounts on the go. We can create account alerts so we know when there's a change. Apply for a loan or credit card. We can even open a new account.
Plus, you can quickly pay bills, transfer money, or make a deposit anytime, anywhere.
Kinetic makes our life a whole lot easier.
Kinetic Credit Union, the energy for your dreams. At Beam, we take pride in being a part of our community, and we're committed to seeing it grow. We continually volunteer with organizations that are making a difference. Together, we are building a better community while building the best internet that exceeds the technology of metropolitan cities. But more importantly, one that connects us all. We want to ensure reliability. So for this reason, we're willing to go the extra mile. We aim to provide the community with high-quality internet and cable services because we live here too. Because at Beam, community is not just a place. It's the way we do business.
Back here in the third period is the River Dragons trailing the Mississippi Seawolves 3-2. Tom Callahan here with you. Third period presented by Kinetic Credit Union. And Columbus, Petrantonio, Bersani, Storjahan out there together. And the faceoff pinballs back towards the point. Anderson trying to step up to keep it in for Columbus. Cannot, because Netzov moving it away to center. Turn back. Here's Petrantonio jamming it in. Wyrick out to backhand it around, didn't get much on it. Storjahan on the near side wall, curling into the slot, feeds it across off the skates of Shinkarik. Shinkarik after it, right side into the corner. Behind the net it goes to Bersani. Bersani backhand up the slot, just out of the reach of Storjahan, and Kuznetsov the other way. Kuznetsov in, feeds it onto the right wing leg of her Helland. Helland couldn't do anything with it. It's put up top, and that's way offside. There we go. We got the whistle. Aslam with a shot after the whistle, and that draws the ire of Petrantonio, as it should. That shot was well after the whistle, and the play was very blatantly offside. And so the cooler heads will prevail here as the linesmen get in between them. 6 minutes, 21 seconds into the third period, 3-2 your score. Right now, the River Dragons still going in fits and starts, as they have last night, as they have tonight. They just don't seem to have the consistency in these last two games. Whether it's the byproduct of an odd week, playing last week only on Friday, and then here this week playing Wednesday, Thursday, before coming home on Friday night, but you know, they still have some time that they're going to need to really start pressing with some scoring chances. Here's Hunter at center. Wheels into the right wing side. Moore looking up top to the left point. Bockwell walks down with a shot, deflects to the corner, and in behind the play, we have a penalty coming up to Hunter. So Hunter is going to head off into the Abercrombie Bonding penalty box for slashing. Time of the penalty, 6:49. Seawolves' fourth power play chance of the evening. They're 1-for-3. Columbus starts with a draw win and a clear just over the line off of David Aslin. Swan out there right now, along with Bersani up front. Duncan and Slahetka on defense. Swan hit the post earlier on a shorthanded chance. Right now, Bersani being extremely pesky. Aslin finally pulling the puck ahead. Left side to Bond. He'll send it around the rim. River Dragons will get there first, though. They sweep it to the point, not out. Held in. Stoya with a long shot. Just missed on the stick side. He was looking for a tip from Bond. Bond up top. Stoya. Stoya into the slot. That one is rejected and sent immediately down the ice by Duncan. Wyrick out to play it. Oh, he gave it right to Bersani. Bersani in the left side corner, tied up by Stoya. But doing a great job chewing off some more of this clock here. Bersani tangled up with Stoya as they both go down to the ice. Back comes Bond, meanwhile, the other way. Trying to move in over the line. Bond put it up on the wall, looking for help, but Slahetka sent it down. And now Bond and Slahetka going after one another. And then Wong comes over, and he and Slahetka jawing. But they separate. So Mississippi moving ahead. Kuznetsov in on the right side. Here's Barr. Barr up top, bomb the long shot, wide of the net. Ends up in the far side corner into the slot. Anderson a one time and he missed. Barr on the right wing, feeding it around to the right point. 24 seconds ago in the Mississippi power play as the puck pushed out by Jemayev. And now Jemayev just hit Bond in the head with a high stick, and he's going to the box. That's a bad penalty. That's a killer. Extra man is on right now. Kuznetsov in front. Nielsen shot tipped over top of the net. And it's going to be 3 seconds of 5-on-3. And Jemayev will be lucky if he only gets 2 minutes. Well, they're going to give him slashing. Could have given high sticking there, but he's into the Abercrombie bonding penalty box as well. Oh, that's a bad one. Columbus is going to have to dig deep now. And Mississippi not taking its timeout right now, but everybody's gathered over at the bench. Referee trying to force him away from the bench to get him in there. Petrantonio has to come back off. They had too many guys out there. Face off to the right of Taylor Joseph. Boy, this is a huge draw right here for Storjahan. He ties it up at the very least. Backhanded along the line, not out. But out of the box is Ryan Hunter. Here's Russell in with a shot and a glove save. Joseph, he'll hang on. And so now, 1:53 to go in the man advantage. It is 5-on-4. Jemayev in there for slashing. 3-2 Seawolves in the lead. 8:54 gone in the third. Draw to the left of Joseph, ends up in the corner. And Columbus chance to clear. They do get it to center. They'll push up. In on the right side. There's a wrist shot. Left pad save Weirich there on that shorthanded attempt by Kyle Moore. Mississippi on the regroup. Aslan will leave it. Stoya left side. Pass ahead to Wong. Wong into the slot. Bond turnaround chance. Bounces in on goal. Joseph the save. Rebound up the far side. Ends up in the corner, Bond, Underwood, trying to turn it up the boards. Moore, still trying to dig it out of there. Chance for Columbus to clear, and it's going to be skated ahead here. River Dragons push, looking for a shorthanded chance on the right side. Underwood with a wrist shot, white, right pad saved there by Blake Weirich. 55 seconds to go on the man advantage. Here's a lead for Nielsen. Too far, but Joseph out to play it. Lost it behind the net. Chance to clear. Columbus will get it down. Just past the halfway mark of the third. 3-2 Mississippi in the lead. Columbus trying to get through the rest of this penalty kill here. Down to 30 seconds of the man advantage now for Mississippi. Russell turning in center. Leaving it off for Kuznetsov. Kuznetsov into the right wing side, cutting wide, in with a shot and a right pad save, rebound to the left point, held in by Russell. Around it goes. Duncan tying his man up. Anderson wrapped it right in front, and that one is taken away and cleared out. Hit the linesman, though, dies at center. 5 seconds ago until Jemayev is onto the box. And now Slahetka on it. He sends it out down the ice as Jemayev onto the penalty box. He's going to put some forecheck pressure on. Weirich has to play it away. Around to the far side, River Dragons pushing in here, trying to make something happen. Weirich leaves it at the side of the net, slid up the near side at the left point. That'll be held in by Duncan. Brody Duncan back down the near wall. Kicks off a stanchion, comes right to Wickline near corner. He'll curl, feeds it up top in the slot. Slahetka lets a wrister go, deflected wide, hit the top of the dasher, comes down to the far corner. Slahetka again, right point. Tried to backhand it in front. That went off a shin pad. Now sent ahead by Kuznetsov. And a race here. Duncan is going to get back for the puck first. Barr at the end of a shift will curl off. Columbus pushing back in left side. Here's Austin Doe. Doe lost the handle on it. And it's flipped back out to center. And now in behind the players, Lucas Helen right off the bench. turning it in front, looking for Bond, but he was tied up. Nice job by Slahecka to get back. Jamath on Wong, can't clear the zone. Wong keeps it in to Bond on the right side, feeds it in on goal. Joseph sticks it away to the corner. Slahecka stretching, can't clear, puck with Russell, slot shot. Missed up high, tried to go high stick. Bond feeds it over to the far side, down for the left point. It's kept in once again by Mississippi. Wickline on it, near side, works it around. Columbus will just wedge the puck out. They need to get at least a partial change here, and they will be able to do just that. 7:48 to go in the third, 3-2 Mississippi. Puck at the line, turned over to Moore. Moore getting it across. McDonald had it go behind him. Bond lost it, though, in the pile. Ends up with Shinkarik. River Dragons looking to move it back on the left wing side. Anderson in over the line, McDonald on the wing. Curl stops on the half boards, into the slot, a little too far in the lead for Shinkarik. Now Moore moving down, wraps it around in front, and that shot shoved wide by McDonald, might have hit Russell in the skates. Moore up top, Shinkarik will let it go. That is blocked in front as well and cleared out by the Seawolves. Shinkarik back, that's an icing call. That's a big icing call right there. Although, with 7:10 left to go in the third, we are going to get immediate timeout, so the Seawolves players will at least get a rest. We're back with more of this Kinetic Credit Union third period in just a moment. Seawolves lead at 3-2. This is River Dragons Hockey.
Even though I'm away at college, Kinetic Credit Union is still the best way for me to stay connected here and at home. With the Kinetic mobile app, I have control of my accounts wherever I go. I can easily transfer money between internal and external accounts, get money faster by setting up recurring transfers, and I can find the nearest ATM or branch right from my phone. Plus, I can add my Kinetic cards to my phone's digital wallet and enjoy quick, secure, contactless payments. By the way, Mom, I need some more money.
Kinetic Credit Union, the energy for your dreams.
Let's go!
Woo! Woo! Yeah! Woo-hoo-hoo! Football time!
Set the tone!
Kyle, tie your shoes, tie your shoes.
Yeah, good job! Woo!
Yeah! Grab a Pepsi Wild Cherry and get wild.
7:10 to go here in the third period. 3-2, Seawolves in the lead. Tom Callahan here with you. Drew Pierce producing here tonight. River Dragons are back home tomorrow night against the Carolina Thunderbirds. 7:35 p.m. and the puck drop for that one. Tickets on sale right now through Ticketmaster.com. And, of course, you can always pick up your seats at the Columbus Civic Center box office as well. Faceoff will be coming up to the right here. Blake Weirich. Hunter, Moore, McDonald out up front. Shinkarik and Anderson on the points. Faceoff will be coming up here in just a moment with McDonald. Chance to win it back towards Shinkarik here over his left shoulder. Seawolves forced to put Russell back out there because of the icing. They couldn't change players, although they did get a 30-second break. Faceoff about to finally get dropped. McDonald does win it back to Shinkarik. His shot pinballs off of Portillo out of the zone, and now the Seawolves go for the change. Portillo on the left side spun himself down to the ice. Lisio with a chance in on net, juggled and held by Taylor Joseph. Faceoff will be to his right. .658 to go into third. River Dragons Hockey brought to you in part by BKI Accounting, a new age approach to old school accounting, specializing in payroll, bookkeeping, income and sales tax for small business. Learn more at bkiaccounting.com. Puck pushed out to center off the defensive zone draw by Columbus, and now back in it goes. Shinkarik, right side, he'll move it across. Moore cross ice to Hunter. Hunter hopped around to check, tries to work his way down the wall, and he's pinned up just past the top of the circles here. And McDonald pokes it out of there in on goal. Weirich electing what to do with it. Backhands it behind the net towards Lind, who's pressured by Petrantonio. Nielsen back the other way. Montanac with the lead through center, tipped down by Lisio. Joseph will leave it at the side of the net. Anderson up the near wall. Pietrantonio tried to tip it off into space, and it's fired right back in. Time ticking down on the River Dragons. 6:05 to go into third period. Columbus trails 3-2. River Dragons need to pull a rabbit out of a hat here sooner or later. As they dump it into the right side of the Seawolves' end of things. Bond spinning away from the forecheck. Puts it to the line, but not out. Kept into the slot a chance, but it rolled away from Storjahan. Into the left side corner is Pietrantonio. And he can't keep it down low. It's played ahead. Aslan up the left side. Bond at center will just hook it in. Right in on goal. And Joseph tried to play it away. Miscommunication with the D. He had to poke it. It's still not out of danger. Bouncing puck finally ends up with Blackwell. Storjahan ahead. Here's Pietrantonio right side. In with a long shot. Blocker save Wyrick. Puck still free side of the net. And that's pushed away by Russell. Storjahan on the bouncer to the right corner. Pietrantonio tried to leave it into space. Russell knocked down. Helen trying to work it free. Pietrantonio after it. Pietrantonio. And now penalty coming up against Mississippi. Storjahan up top. One time shot. That finds the glass as Underwood let it go. Out to center it is. And touched up there by Barr. And now Mississippi will be shorthanded. Russell complaining on his way into the box. But it's going to be a cross-checking call when we come back. River Dragons on the power play. 4:58 to go in regulation. 3-2 Seawolves. More coming your way on River Dragons Hockey.
We all dream. But dreams quickly become distant memories unless we do something about it. Do everything in our power to learn to lead. At Troy University, we teach everyone to be leaders in their field. We're dedicated to teaching a new generation to lead change.
I'm always on the go. But with the Kinetic Credit Union app, Kinetic is always with me. The Kinetic mobile app is virtual banking at its best. With the Kinetic mobile app, I can easily send and receive money, make a deposit, pay some bills, and I can even open up a new account, all from my phone. And I can monitor all my accounts in one place, all on the go. The Kinetic mobile app, energized banking at its best.
Kinetic Credit Union, the energy for your dreams.
4:58 left here in the third. 3-2 Seawolves in the lead, but the River Dragons onto the Loft power play. The Loft features live music every Friday and Saturday night. Show your River Dragons ticket stuff for a 2-for-1 deal on cover only at the Loft. A proud partner of Columbus River Dragons Hockey. And don't forget your next Chick-fil-A Midland Kissin' 99.3 Family 4-Pack is coming up March 16th, Faith and Family Night, and then April 13th, Fan Appreciation Night. $40 gets you 4 tickets, 4 hot dogs, 4 popcorns, 4 Pepsi products, and 4 Chick-fil-A coupons. That's over $100 in value for just $40. Only available through the River Dragons office. Call 706-507-4625. That's 507-4625. All right, here we go. Big power play for the River Dragons. They have the 5 out there. Storjahan in for the faceoff. It's tied up on the dot, one back by Anderson, but quickly after it, here's Kyle Moore. Moore on the far side, battling in the corner, knocked down, but keeps the puck, at least for the moment, fed behind the net. Pietrantonio on it. He'll get it around to the left point, McDonald. McDonald up top to Doe. They'll switch. Doe, McDonald, one time, lets it go off the goal post. Pietrantonio near circle, his drive, blocker save, rebound free. Moore tried to shove it in front, couldn't get it through, and it's cleared out. Second post of the game for the River Dragons. Joseph will leave it aside for Slahetka. River Dragons changing up some personnel fairly quickly here. They push ahead right side. Here's Austin Doe moving in over the line. Cross ice feed. Here's Slahetka down into the slot. A chance hooked on goal. Save made. Storjahan on the rebound. He'll feed it up top to Doe. Doe over to McDonald. Top of the far circle. McDonald into the slot. Moore turns it on goal and a glove save. Wyrick. Oh, look what I found. Blake Wyrick. And boy, he had the mitt on the hip. And that's right where Moore put the shot. .101 to go on the power play. Columbus is going to shuffle the five right back out there. Taylor Joseph remains in the net, under four to go in regulation. 3-2 Seawolves. Up to the left point, here's McDonald. McDonald in front, and that one wide, maybe looking for a tip. Doe down for the right point, keeps it alive. Behind the net, Moore to the near dot, Petrantonio. Petrantonio in the slot, shot tipped, out of play off the stick of Storjahan. Faceoff will remain once again in the Seawolves zone. 3:40 to go in the third, 43 seconds to go. And the cross-checking call against Russell. McDonald in to take this face-off. Tries to dig it back. Petrantonio in to help out. Gets it up top to Storjahan. Storjahan out with it up top. McDonald right side. Top of the blue line. Doe over. Petrantonio one-timer. And the save made by Weirich. Rebound to the far side. Clear to the line. And it is not kept in. As it rolls out just over the blue line, Columbus tried to turn back in. They could not. 20 seconds of the man advantage. Petrantonio looking to lead that one ahead. McDonald in over the line. They whistle it down on the offside. They're going to stay all the way down with this faceoff. 3:12 to go here in the third. 14 seconds to go in the man advantage for the River Dragons. 3-2, Seawolves lead, and time is really running down on Columbus. Jemayev able to win the faceoff back to Shinkarik. He'll move it up the right side. Now here they come in over the line. Here's a chance, Shinkarik, and he scores! Carter Shinkarik with a wrist shot that surprises Weirich on the stick side. It's a power play goal for the River Dragons off the rush. They tie it with 3:01 to go. Shinkarik's got his second of the night and his 13th of the season. That is some timely goal scoring. Wow. This Columbus team, even when they're not playing their best game, they might even be playing one of their worst in a while, but they're still finding a way. And that is the mark of something special. When sometimes you just have to claw and you have to scrap and you somehow still hang around. River Dragons push back in now. Here's Jemayev in with a shot and a save. Weirich, he'll hang on. 2:47 to go in the third, tied at three. Oh, the plot thickens. So now, I'm sure Columbus would love to not see OT in this one. And they've got the momentum right now for the first time in a long time. Jemayev with the assist on the Shinkarik goal. And Columbus pushing the puck behind the net. Out in front, Petrantonio, a shot, missed the net. Around it goes and out. Shinkarik will feed it back over to Anderson. Anderson up the right side. And that might have gone off Bersani. Either way, out of play. We get a whistle. 2:29 to go here in the third. Tied at three. Off of me just outside the Columbus blue line. McDonald in for the faceoff. Seawolves win it back. Here's Russell on the right side. He'll swing it back across. Seawolves bank it ahead. Bond tipping it down. Joseph out to scoot it around to the near side. Bockwell up the near boards. Here's Hunter. Hunter looking ahead. Left there by McDonald. Hunter, left side in with a wrist shot. Fought off by Weirich. Right side, Moore. Puck to the point. Sent right back down the wall. Hunter in the corner on the bouncer. Lets it go to McDonald. McDonald tried to tip it through traffic in front. Puck still not out of danger. Drifts to the right point now. Underwood steps down, keeps it alive. Bouncer on the half wall. Hunter is tied up. And the Seawolves will lift the wedge back out to center. Bockwell on it there. He hits it back across. River Dragons push in, but offside. 1:42 to go in the third, tied at three. So I heard it's Kyle Russell's birthday tonight. Everybody on the yard, let's say happy birthday to him. How about it? It's Wickline, Chamath, Duncan, Slahetka, and Austin Doe. Doe helping that draw back. Duncan over Slahetka, but he gave it up. Lissio pushing it on the left side into the left wing corner. Jamath back defensively to help out. Works it around the rim to Wickline. Wickline out to center. Doe pushing in past Aslan. Austin Doe in on the backhand right across the goal mouth. Nobody there. Wickline curling up high. Feeds it over for a one-time. Slahetka ripped it wide. And now it's tossed up in the air out to center. Bouncing puck comes down right in front of Duncan. Duncan will push in with it on the left wing. Lind will beat him to it. Duncan goes back to be defensively responsible. Turned over the Wickline into the slot looking for Doe. Doe, traffic in front, shot blocked. Off to the left point, there's Duncan. And oh, that just pinballed wide to the near post on a deflection. Left point, Duncan trying to keep the puck in. Portillo trying to push it out. They tie up right on the blue line over it. River Dragons changing behind the play. 44 seconds ago in regulation. We're tied at three. Seawolves up the right side. Here's Barr. Backhands it in front. Tipped away by Shinkarik. Petrantonio the other way. Lead too far for Bersani. Petrantonio following it up as the puck ends up in the Seawolves bench. 29.8 seconds to go in the third. Tied at three. Face-off will be just outside the Seawolves line in front of the Mississippi bench. Bersani, Storjahan, Petrantonio out up front. Shinkarik and Anderson on the points. Chopped over to an open side of the ice. Anderson stepping up. He'll fire it in for Columbus. It ends up in the far side corner. Petrantonio around to the right point. Shinkarik. Up top, his wrister through traffic. Save made. Wyrick rebound in front. Petrantonio can't get to it. 13 seconds, and now Lucas Helland will move ahead. Gives it to Kuznetsov. Kuznetsov wide on the right side. Puck in tight. A shot to his left. Joseph the save, and he's got it. Big stop with 3.8 seconds to go. Wow. That was so close. Taylor Joseph, little bit of a juggle, but he had it. Oh my, that is by far the biggest save of the contest. Face off to the left of Joseph. We are 3.8 seconds away from getting to overtime, but big draw here. McDonald knocks Wong down, puck into the slot. Nielsen, a shot blocked in front, and we are indeed gonna go to some 3-on-3, tied at three. Oh my goodness. The River Dragons with a chance. Maybe not 3 points in regulation, but still a chance to win it, but it didn't look like they'd have one. But they do. What a finish to that third period. Shots 15-13 in favor of Columbus in the third. And that late goal by Shinkarik. 16:59, time of the equalizer. So now it's 5 minutes of 3-on-3 sudden death. And then after that, if we do, we go to a shootout if we're still tied. Off. Coming up at center, let's see who the River Dragons are going to put out. It looks like Ryan Hunter. along with McDonald. Of course, whenever I want to see the guy's numbers, they don't want to turn their back to me. So it's McDonald, Hunter, and I believe that's Blackwell out there as well. All right, here we go. Wong against McDonald for the faceoff. And it's one back by McDonald. Blackwell will handle, and he'll carry it all the way back behind his own net. Watch by Bond. Blackwell left side, ahead to McDonald. McDonald at center. Hunter was knocked down and slid across the line. He's back up now. And McDonald trying to push in on the right wing. Leaned on by Wong, lost it. Here's Stoya. Stoya with a lead to Bond on the right side. He's up one-on-one. Bond working his way in. Cross ice pass and over to his right. Joseph the save, and he hangs on. Oh, my goodness. Columbus, difficulty on the rush there. That's a big save in the overtime. First opportunity goes for the Mississippi Seawolves. So now it's Petrantonio, Doe, and Shinkarik. And the River Dragons again win the draw. Shinkarik back. Moves it ahead to Austin Doe, and Doe with Petrantonio, they'll push up 2-on-2. Here's Doe on the right side. Petrantonio going to the net, in on the backhand, hooked up, got a shot away. Weirich the save, and he'll hang on to the rebound. And Petrantonio had a stick broken in half there, trying to get to that puck. He's got to go get a new twig. Where 4:15, potentially left in this overtime. 5 minute, 3-on-3, sudden death, tied at 3. Draw to the right of Weirich. Draw pushed over to Doe. Doe to the left point. Shinkarik looking for an angle to his right. Lets it go through traffic. Oh boy, that one found the glass. Weirich never saw it. Petrantonio behind the net, trying to loop it out in front. Petrantonio curling, feeds it over to the wall, but coughed it up to Russell. Russell in his own end, watched by both Doe and Petrantonio, does manage to get it ahead. Seawolves having trouble breaking ahead. Here's Nielsen, and he puts the pass behind Russell. They're just going to head for a change. Columbus will do the same here. Shinkarik turning back out the right side of the net. And Carter Shinkarik, he's got two. Can he get three? Shinkarik into the wing with a wrist shot, and that one is deflected wide of the net. Shinkarik ends up with a puck. He's going to carry it all the way back out to center. He's got to head for a change. And Columbus again on the regroup here. Looping back into his own end is Alexander Jemayev. Underwood out there with him in wick line. Now here's Jemayev driving up the right side. He's pushed off, ran into the linesman. Puck turned over to Mississippi. Back they come on the left side. Chance in front, pass block, rebounded on goal, and that one is stopped by Taylor Joseph. Boy, Joseph has had to be solid here in the OT, make a couple of saves. He had to make one with 3.8 seconds left just to get it to overtime. Moore, McDonald, Slahetka now out there. And up front, it's Barr, Helland, and I believe that's Lind on the far side for the Seawolves. So let's see this faceoff. Now they're going to toss McDonald out, so Kyle Moore has to take the draw. And it's one back towards Lind up top, but he fans on it, and now it's pushed ahead. And here's Nolan Slahecka trying to move in. He's wrapped up by Lind, though, couldn't get a scoring chance. Lucas Helland has to play it around to Lind, and now Lind will push it ahead. Up the right side, 2-on-1 developing. Lind in, pass across, they score! Justin Barr with the overtime game winner. And the Seawolves beat the River Dragons 4-3 in overtime. So the crowd victorious here at home, Mississippi. Fans on their feet. The River Dragons dejectedly heading off the ice. 4-3, Seawolves win it in OT. We're into the Pepsi postgame show. Three stars of the game coming your way, along with a final wrap-up of the out-of-town scoreboard and the scoring as well. More coming your way. This is Columbus River Dragons hockey.
Let's go!
Woo! Woo! Yeah! Woo! Football time!
Set the tone!
Kyle, tie your shoes, tie your shoes.
Yeah, good job!
Woo!
Yeah! Grab a Pepsi Wild Jerry and get wild.
Don't miss your chance to win at Victory Land Casino. We're open 24/7, so come on in for nonstop gaming action. You'll find the latest, hottest, most exciting games around, and you'll love the fun bonuses and big jackpots. Plus, you can watch and wager on horse and greyhound races from all over the world. Your best bet for big wins is just minutes away at Victory Land Casino, where you can be a winner too. Victory Land Casino, located off I-85 exit 22 in Shorter, Alabama. Must be 21 or older.
At Jack Houston Memorial Hospital, our focus is you. Even though we performed more than 1,300 joint replacements last year, we treat you like you are our only patient. Your surgeon explains your joint replacement, so nothing is a surprise. Our team knows your treatment plan, and we work together to get you back on your feet again. That's why our hospital is recognized year after year as a leader in patient satisfaction and quality of care. Jack Houston Memorial Hospital. Excellence, always.
And here with you as they're calling out the three stars down there on the ice.
Fans, don't forget our next game is tomorrow.
And Lucas Helen, your first star. Helen with an assist on the game-winning goal. And he also had a goal in the game. Second star was number 10, Philip Wong. And Wong tonight also had a goal and an assist. And the third star with the game-winning goal in overtime. Justin Barr for the Seawolves. That was his eighth of the year from Helen and Linda, 2-11. And it gives Mississippi the 4-3 overtime win. Three stars tonight presented by Wade Cleaners. Wade Cleaners, the official cleaners of Scorch and Torch. We are back with more in a moment in the Pepsi postgame show. Scoring wrap in the out-of-town scoreboard coming your way. This is River Dragons Hockey.
Ice Spice?
Wait, who's that?
It's my ex, Lemon Lime Soda.
You're looking well.
I just needed something more refreshing, more crisp. I'm with Starry now.
This is intense.
He's so vulnerable.
But I love you. Please.
Ah, buddy, it'll be okay.
Or not.
Huh, Starry does taste better.
Hi-ho, hi-ho, your gas is getting low, but you're in luck, pull your car or truck into Zelmo's, Zelmo's, Zelmo's.
This month at Zelmo's, all Celsius energy drinks, 2 for $4.
But you're in luck, pull your car or truck into Zelmo's, Zelmo's, Zelmo's.
Always clean, always fast, always friendly. Zelmo's Zip-In, fueling life's passions for 20 years.
Winter is upon us. We must prepare. Cold and darkness will spread across the land. The nights will be long.
Hey, what are you guys doing? Air Force is here to fix the heat.
Don't let winter leave you out in the cold. Call Air Force Heating and Air now for our special $79 AC gas furnace or heat pump tune-up, only for a limited time. Air Force Heating and Air is always here for you.
Hello there. My name is Seychelle, and what makes the Chick-fil-A chicken sandwich original to me is that punch of flavors that's unlike any other. You get the crispy tenderness of the chicken and that hint of sourness from the pickles. Ta-da!
Hey, I'm Juan, and what makes the Chick-fil-A chicken sandwich original to me is every single time you take a bite, you know you're gonna get chicken that's crispy, golden, and juicy. The Chick-fil-A chicken sandwich is the gold standard of chicken sandwiches. There's no touching it.
For 3, your final here this evening. Columbus on the short end of the stick in the Pepsi postgame show. Let's go back through and take a look back at the scoring summary in this one. River Dragons actually got out to a 1-0 lead in this one, 5:08 into the game. Kyle Moore is 21st from Justin McDonald, Brian Hunter. The scoring streak continues now, 31 games to the point for Justin McDonald. An incredible league record that he continues to extend night in and night out. But a couple of goals end by the Seawolves, a power play marker from Justin Bond, Wong, and Portillo. The assist at 9:59, and at 18:47, Lucas Helland is 4th from Lind and Aslan. And it's 2-1. After one period of play. Into the second we go. Columbus ties it right back up. 50 seconds in. Shinkarik is first of two on the night. His 12th from Storjahan and Bersani to make it 2-2. But then at 4:27, Wong, his 13th from Nilsson and Montanac. And before the end of the intermission, the River Dragons found themselves trailing once again, this time 3-2 to the Seawolves heading into the third. High drama in the third period. Columbus had to fight to tie this one up, but they finally did with 3:01 left to go in regulation time. Shinkarik scores off the rush on the power play with a wrist shot, his second of the night, 13th of the year from Alexander Jemayev, and that would force overtime. But in the OT at 2:11, Justin Barr, his 8th, is the game winner, and he ends up with assists from Helland and Lind, and that is the difference in this one for the Seawolves as they pull off a big win here on home ice. Shots by period for the River Dragons, 11 in the first, 12 in the second, 15 in the third, 1 in overtime for 39, 5, 8, 13, and 3 for the Seawolves, 29 in total in the game. Power play, Seawolves finished 1 for 5, and the River Dragons 0 for 4. We'll take a break, come back, wrap things up in the Pepsi postgame show with a final look back at the out-of-town scoreboard, which is brought to you by Zelmo's Zip-In. Zelmo's has been fueling life's passion since 1999. Stay tuned. More coming your way in just a moment. This is River Dragons Hockey.
We all dream, but dreams quickly become distant memories unless we do something about it. Do everything in our power to learn to lead. At Troy University, we teach everyone to be leaders in their field. We're dedicated to teaching a new generation to lead change.
Going a million different directions.
But Kinetic Credit Union makes it easy for all of us to stay connected all in one place.
With the Kinetic mobile app, we both can monitor our accounts on the go. We can create account alerts so we know when there's a change, apply for a loan or credit card. We can even open a new account.
Plus, you can quickly pay bills, transfer money, or make a deposit anytime, anywhere.
Kinetic makes our life a whole lot easier.
Kinetic Credit Union, the energy for your dreams.
What? Tim Hortons has a new $6 breakfast bundle? With a mouthwatering breakfast sandwich, a golden hash brown with a small hot or iced coffee, and a classic donut made for your me time. Oh, and yours too. The $6 breakfast bundle.
Just the two of us. We can make it if we try. Just the two of us. Just the two of
us. Get two entrees and an appetizer for $25 only at Applebee's.
Pepsi postgame show. Tom Callahan, Drew Pierce, and look back now at that Zelmo Zip-In out of town scoreboard. Finals from the NHL tonight. The Bruins 4-1 over the Maple Leafs. 4-1 Hurricanes top the Canadiens. Blue Jackets 4-2 over the Oilers. 2-1 Flyers over the Panthers tonight. 4-1 Devils over the Blues. 6-0 Capitals over the Penguins. Flames 6, Lightning 3. Preds double up the Sabres 4-2. Game's going on right now. Wild up 1-0 on the Coyotes after 2. After 20 minutes, the Canucks 2-0 up on top of the Golden Knights. Senators and Kings just underway, scoreless in the first there, and the Islanders an early 1-0 lead over the Sharks in the first period of that game. Men's college basketball for you. Late in the second, Washington continues to lead number 18 Washington State 63-60. Number 5 Arizona out in front of UCLA 52-33. Early in the second half of that one, so Arizona looking for a statement win over UCLA, that's for sure. And the NHL trade tracker here as we keep an eye on what's going on. Trade deadline coming up tomorrow. Another one coming in here this evening. Left wing Anthony Duclair and a 25 seventh round pick to the Tampa Bay Lightning for defenseman Jack Thompson and a 24 third round pick to the San Jose Sharks. So teams wheeling and dealing right now. And you know what? We're going to have a lot more to talk about in the broadcast tomorrow night after the 3 p.m. deadline passes. Plenty of question marks still hanging out there for teams. Are they going to go for it? And who are they going to try to acquire? Will the prices be paid? I guess we'll find out tomorrow. So, all right, well, one more time here. Your final score in overtime. The Mississippi Seawolves, for just the second time in franchise history, win a game from the Columbus River Dragons. And the other win, by the way, came early last season. It was actually a shutout victory right here at the Mississippi Gulf Coast Coliseum. So now I believe the lifetime series has come to now 21-1-1 in favor of the River Dragons. But the overtime victory here tonight for the Seawolves, at least Columbus does get a point. They go to 102 on the season and continue to hold that big lead in the Continental Division. We'll talk to you tomorrow night, everybody. 7:35 puck drop back in Columbus as they take on the Carolina Thunderbirds. And that game, again, Sensory Awareness Night in conjunction with Easter Seals. Tickets on sale right now through Ticketmaster.com, or you can come down to the Civic Center box office tomorrow during normal business hours and right up till game time. And we hope to see you there. 4-3 your final in OT. Seawolves beat the River Dragons. Thank you so much for listening and watching and being a part of Columbus River Dragons hockey. This is Tom Callahan saying good night.
Thank you for being a part of Columbus River Dragons hockey. This game was brought to you in part by Pepsi, the official soft drink of the Columbus River Dragons. Zelmo Zip-In, the official fuel provider of the River Dragons. Air Force Heating and Air, the official heating and air company of the River Dragons. Country Inn and Suites, the official host hotel of the River Dragons. And by Chick-fil-A Midland, Tim Hortons, Columbus Diagnostic, Shredaway, the Overbeat Company, Vector Ply, Trivioli's, The Jersey Shop, Beam TV, WYBU Christian Television Network, Troy University, Largeman Dental, BKI Accounting, The Optical Shop, Piggly Wiggly, Sun South John Deere, Wade Cleaners, Houston Clinic, Abercrombie Bonding, First Franklin Financial, and Old School Barber Shop. This has been a presentation of Ignite Sports and Entertainment. Any rebroadcast, retransmission, or any other use is prohibited without the express written consent of Ignite Sports and Entertainment and the Columbus River Dragons. This has been a presentation of the Columbus River Dragons.